5 of their first 8 games, and things quickly started to go south, giving up a lot of points per game, and that led to a 6-6 regular season record and the resignation of Marshall alum Mark Snyder, gone after 5 seasons in which Marshall never had a winning record. And on December 17th, John Doc Holliday hired away from cross-state rival West Virginia. He is not on the sidelines, however, for this game. Defensive coordinator Rick Minter, the interim head coach, Ray, for 1 game.
And Coach Minter was very impressive when we talked to him. He has been in this situation. He understands. He thinks he's got his Marshall football team focused to win this ball game. He was the head coach at Cincinnati for 10 years, took them to 4 bowls. And he's also confident because he has what is probably the best player on the field here this afternoon in Darius Marshall. Marshall coming off of a high ankle sprain, ready to go today. And he has great vision that is closely tied to very quick feet. And the result of that is his ability to cut and move either way.
On the Ohio sideline for the 5th year is Frank Solich. 2 games over 500, as you see, but taking them to 2 bowl games in their last 4 years, brought over a lot of Nebraska Cornhuskers from his staff when he left Lincoln to come to Athens. Marshall won the toss, but has deferred. Ohio will receive. The band in full force. These two schools located about 80 miles apart. And a very interesting opening kick formation right off the bat for Marshall. Craig Tamaran, their kicker. Now they get back into the more conventional lineup.
Yeah, they take that bunch about every time. Sometimes they'll run out of that one.
We are underway at the Little Caesars Bowl. Dante Harden slips as he got the opening kickoff, and because his knee hit the ground, he is down. So here comes a touchback. We already talked about the quarterback for Ohio, Theo Scott. He's a senior from Long Beach, California. Been playing on a sore ankle for much of the season, but already his 19 touchdown passes among the best in school history. Boo Jackson had 19 touchdown passes last year. Jackson had a season-ending shoulder injury earlier this year, which brought on Scott.
Yeah, they were kind of battling for who was going to be that guy, and it was kind of a toss-up, and then Boo got hurt, and Theo took over.
First snap of the game, and they give it to the running back, Chris Garrett, who picked up 1 yard. This Ohio offense really has struggled at times, especially in the red zone. Already talked about Theo Scott beating him with his feet as well as his arm. Chris Garrett, 2nd in Ohio history in all-purpose yards. He's also a dangerous returner. They have some great receivers. And up front, sophomore A.J. Strum has not given up a sack all season at his left guard position. 2nd and 9 for the Bobcats. Scott with a little fake and then throws it. It should have been picked off. Originally, that was Ashton Hall, who was very much around the football all season long with the play.
Yeah, Ashton Hall jumped the bootleg. They were trying to hit the tight end coming across Jordan Thompson, and Hall, had he caught that one, he could have gone to the house for 6. And you can see Marshall very well scouted on what the Bobcats like to do. He just jumped that route. Should have had an interception.
But instead, it's 3rd and 9, opening drive of the game for Ohio. Scott has protection breakdown. That's Albert McClellan in pursuit. He just throws it up, and the jump ball is indeed picked off this time. Now it's incomplete. Boy, Ahmed Shakur had a golden opportunity for an interception. Scott, very fortunate it wasn't picked.
Yeah, it was almost like a punt. Theo Scott, he shows you the feet and the ability to get out and try to extend the play. And Shakur comes down with the ball, but it's ripped away by Taylor Price. And if Theo Scott had a bigger arm, he could have got that thing to Price. Price had a couple of yards on Shakur. As it is, the Bobcats will have to punt after almost throwing 2 interceptions. A shaky start for Theo Scott.
And here is a new punter for Ohio. This is Paul Hershey. Matt Schulte, the usual punter, is not here today because of a violation of team rules. Hershey's done some kicking, mostly rugby style. And that one takes a friendly Bobcat bounce. Not a bad punt at all for Hershey. That's a 51-yarder. Marshall's first time with the football. Brian Anderson, the junior from Louisville, is their quarterback, Ray.
His first year of starting, and to me, Brian Anderson is a very courageous quarterback. He will stand in there to deliver the football and take some serious shots. He loves to move up in the pocket. I think he runs this offense very well. Not as much of a threat to pull it down and run it, but he does have good movement within the pocket.
His coaches say he is athletic enough to extend the play, but he is not going to win any great athleticism contests. And there's Darius Marshall. Ray says he's the best player on the field today, and he picked up 3 on his very first carry. Marshall missed the last 2 games of the regular season with a hurt ankle, but he should be close to 100% today. And a change up front. Chris Bowers, a redshirt freshman, starting for Chad Schofield, the usual center, who is out, hurt his ankle, and then had an infection in the ankle that had to that landed Schofield in the hospital. So we'll see how Bowers does with very little experience at center. 2nd and 6, little swing pass, complete to Marshall. And he is taken down about 1 yard upfield by Noah Keller, one of the very active linebackers for this team. Dak Noahstein, a former walk-on, leads the Bobcats in sacks. You already saw Keller with a play. He and Lee Renfro really the real leaders at linebacker. Gerald Morton, Patrick Tafua combined to pick off 9 passes for this Ohio team. Again, Ohio is terrific. In fact, first in bowl subdivision with 36 forced turnovers on the season. Marshall out of the backfield. Now Martin Ward, number 29, stands next to Anderson on 3rd down.
Bobcats love the blitz in this situation. They bring it.
And they get to Anderson just a tick too late, but it forces him to throw it behind his intended receiver, Chuck Walker. So both offenses start with a 3-and-out.
Great pressure from that blitz. Marshall was not able to pick it up. And we have a pretty exciting punt returner for the Ohio Bobcats in Levon Brazil, man. 4 career punt returns for a touchdown. He's a special guy. When he gets it in open field, it's a scary situation for that coverage team.
And 3 of those 4 touchdowns from punt returns this season. The only player in the bowl subdivision with 3 punt returns for scores this year. Case Whitehead with the punt. Keep your eye on number 7, Brazil. Nice hang time, and Brazil is met. Good coverage downfield by Marshall on the always dangerous punt returner. 39-yard punt, 3-yard return, Brandon Burns. Good coverage by the linebacker to get Brazil down. We're coming back to Detroit.
AT&T is the nation's fastest 3G network, so you can download faster on your smartphone than Verizon. To prove it, I'm downloading myself on both networks at the same time. AT&T download's done. Verizon, sorry, your time's up. This AT&T download. Hi.
When you compare, there's no comparison.
Oh, no, this...
AT&T.
That's just not right.
A better 3G experience. This holiday, get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Is Ed too tall, Jones? Too tall?
I'm just gonna guesstimate.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
I'm all shook up.
Welcome to the first Little Caesars Pizza Bowl. I'm Dave Scrivano, president of Little Caesars,
with legendary coaches George Perlis and Lloyd Carr.
College football and Little Caesars Pizza.
Doesn't get any better than this.
I couldn't agree more, Coach. And to celebrate, Little Caesars all across the country will be offering an incredible deal this weekend on a large hot and ready pizza. Stay tuned for details during the game.
Happy holidays from the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl.
Enjoy the game! Yeah!
Pizza, pizza.
We are back at the Little Caesars Bowl. There is a Marshall fan. A lot of green on the field. Ohio in the all green uniforms with the ball for the second time, and they are already put in their backup quarterback, Tyler Tettleton, a true freshman out of Norman, who is in to take a snap for Theo Scott.
Hey, they'd like to work him in early in the game with this fly sweep series.
Brazil, who we just saw with the punt return, picks up enough yardage, should be a first down. Shakur made the stop for this Marshall defense. They give up about 25 points per game. Albert McClellan, very good on the edge. Linebacker Mario Harvey, the most explosive linebacker Rick Minter says he has ever coached. And in the backfield, Ashton Hall, we've already seen him make a couple of plays. Loves to play football. He's a tremendous athlete. He's the kind of guy who bugs his coaches to put him in on every special team.
Yeah. He always wants to return the punts and the kickoffs.
Theo Scott back in at quarterback for the Bobcats, playing in the all greens. Brazil in motion, but instead the handoff to Garrett on first down. And Chris picks up about four. Hall and Harvey with the stop, two of the stars of this Marshall defense. Let's take a look at today's impact players brought to you by Prevacid.
Mavon Brazil, we've already seen him try to return a punt and then run for a first down on that jet sweep series. Taylor Price, their leading wide receiver, as fast as anybody out on the field. He's their deep guy. And then on the other side, Mario Harvey, you mentioned him, Pam. I was watching him on film, and he knocks people out. He is fun to watch if you like good defense and hard hitting.
Which Ray does, yes, all of the above. Mario Harvey, number 30 in white, if you want to keep your eye on him. There's a completion to Taylor Price, the most prolific receiver in Ohio history. Picks up a first down, and Harvey was there to stop him.
Yeah, Harvey comes off, but it's just going to be a press coverage situation, and then a quick slant inside. The timing of the pass is immaculate. You see Theo Scott, he's sometimes a little stiff in terms of his mechanics. He'll hold the ball high throughout his drop, but when he is hot and relaxed, he is an excellent thrower of the football, very accurate. He's kind of streaky sometimes.
58% completion rate for Scott this year. Second first down of this drive. Garrett trying to go over the left side, picks up about 3 yards. John Jacobs making the stop for the Thundering Herd.
This Ohio run game has been problematic throughout the course of the season, Pam, especially when they get down inside the red zone. They don't have a big back who can hammer things in there. They've got Garrett, he's 185. Vince Davidson, 189-pounder. They bring in Dante Harden, he's 181. And L.J. Flintall, 187. They've got the same guy, but they've got four of them.
Second and 7. Scott flares it out to Brazil. He is stopped a couple of yards short of the first down. So they don't have a big power back. They use the pistol, and they like to run out of that a lot.
Yeah, the staff went to Nevada to learn the pistol from Chris Ault and his group, and they love the downhill handoff, the mesh point of having that tailback behind the quarterback in a shotgun situation. And then it forces defenses to play base. Because of the pistol, you can go either way on it. Defenses aren't apt to really blitz you much. And then the quick passing game is still there out of that shotgun. So that's the philosophy. And it fits this Ohio Bobcat personnel to a T. I think it was a great decision by Coach Solich to go to that scheme in the offseason.
First flag of the game. We have an amalgamated crew here.
Ohio, your first charge timeout.
Actually, not a flag. It's a timeout. Robert Cameron, our referee. We have officials from the WAC, the Mountain West, and Conference USA working this game. So timeout on the field, 3rd and 3, coming up for the Bobcats.
You want to score a deal on dinner? Then listen up, because this play is money. Everybody, cut right to your computer and type in littlecaesars.com. print the coupon there, and you get a large, freshly made, hot and ready pizza for an incredible $3.99. $3.99? This place is going wild, but it's good for 2 days only, so the clock is running. Get to Little Caesars with your coupon and seal the deal tonight.
Pizza, pizza.
Announcing the Lincoln Wishlist sales event. With short-term 27-month leases on the latest in luxury and technology. But hurry to the Lincoln Wishlist sales event because these special 27-month leases will be gone soon. Now, lease a Lincoln MKZ for 27 months for only $329 a month during the Lincoln Wishlist sales event at your Lincoln Mercury dealer.
Opportunity. At Amway Global, it's the foundation of our business. Because Opportunity built Nutrilite, the world's top-selling vitamin, mineral, and supplement brand. And Artistry, one of the world's best-selling beauty brands, which makes Amway Global the online health and beauty leader. And worldwide, Amway has over $8 billion in annual sales. For your opportunity to be part of this success and to start making more money for yourself, contact an Amway Global independent business owner or visit amwayglobal.com.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
Show me the Carfax.
Hi, I'm your Carfax. Buy the car, you're gonna love it.
He said Carfax.
Same thing, huh?
A Carfax report can help you choose a great used car. It's free at thousands of reputable dealers. Just say, show me the Carfax.
ESPN College Football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by Little Caesars Pizza, home of the large hot and ready pizza, always fresh, always ready. Your Lincoln Mercury dealer, bringing you the latest in luxury and technology. And Amway Global, celebrating 50 years of making better products for better lives.
Welcome back to Detroit. That's a scene from yesterday. Players from both schools serving meals at the Salvation Army here in Detroit. The city hit so hard, probably the hardest of any major city in the United States by the economic downturn, and a huge dose of reality and a nice gesture by those young men to go out and help some unfortunate folks on Christmas Day. After the timeout, third and three for the Bobcats, trying to keep this drive alive. Brazil in motion as usual, and he gets the football. That's terrific! Ashton Hall coming up from his safety spot, blazes in and drops Brazil for a 5-yard loss.
Yeah, Ashton Hall, they love to play him as the eighth man in the box, and they'll bring him up and he will just come in and make a play. Hall is right over here, and watch him get through this thing, fight his way through the traffic, and then fight off a blocker and then come and penetrate and make the play. They kind of had a defense stacked. They knew LaVon Brazil was going to get that football as soon as he started in motion.
Boy, Hall making the play, now is back at the 10, waiting for the punt from Paul Hershey. His first one was 51 yards. This is a skyscraper. Hall wisely calls for the fair catch, and then it takes Marshall bounce backwards.
And a little backspin on that one.
Now let's take a look at the impact players, the Prevacid impact players. On this side for Marshall.
Antavius Wilson is their deep threat guy, and we will see him, and we will see Anderson take a couple of deep shots towards him. We have seen Darius Marshall already. He's just getting warmed up. He is an exciting open field slashing type runner. And on the other side for the Bobcats, Noah Keller, you see the production for him, 138 tackles over the course of the season. Just a kid with a nose for the football and an indomitable will to get there.
Keller making some All-American teams this year. Marshall with the football. Darius coming back. Again, we mentioned that he had missed a couple of games with a hurt ankle. Picks up 4 yards. Keller making the stop on that play.
He's a classic cutback type runner, Pam, with great balance. And, you know, he's one of those guys where his eyes are really connected tightly with his feet. And he can see something, and then he does it without even thinking. And the cutback acceleration is really what his trademark is.
Only a junior, just completed his second straight 1,000-yard season in the backfield. Aaron Dobson, a true freshman, number 3 in motion, but they give it back to Marshall, and he is cut down in the backfield. There's a flag on the play. Notestein coming up to make the play for Ohio.
Notestein did a great job of penetrating upfield. He beat the blocker from the inside out. Usually you try to fight that thing and not get hooked. He got hooked initially, dipped the shoulder, got the penetration, and then flattened it out, made the tackle for the loss.
Robert Cameron is our referee this afternoon.
Illegal block below the waist. Number 16 on the offense. Half the distance to the goal. Second down.
Tight end Lee Smith. You cannot block below the waist if you come from the outside in. And that's the illegal chop block that they're talking about. And here he is, number 16. Sorry, right up here. And you see he's outside in, and you cannot block below the waist, and he hit Noah Keller low. That's a good rule for player safety, which has been a huge point of emphasis for officiating this year.
Brings up a second and 18. Anderson, the little screen. Keller making the play on Marshall, who only gets a couple of yards on that play.
Great neck recognition by Noah Keller. He initially dropped into his pass route, planted the foot, saw the screen set up, came underneath the wave of blockers to get in there and make his third tackle here early in the ball game.
Had a mess of tackles, in fact, 16 in the MAC title game loss to Central Michigan. That is an all-time MAC title game record, and that game is played right here at Ford Field. Third and 16, Marshall fighting an uphill battle on this series. Anderson under duress throws it, and that's a leaping grab by Lee Smith. Smith, the huge tight end, picked up 24 yards, and they moved the chains.
This is what Brian Anderson does so well. Hangs in the pocket, takes a hit, and still delivers the ball down the field. And Lee Smith goes up high and catches it. And Smith was just kind of waiting for his opportunity to be a pass catcher in this offense, because their All-American Cody Slate was that main guy. Slate got injured in the 10th week of the year, and Lee Smith has emerged as an excellent receiver.
They needed 16 yards, they got 24. Smith, a huge target at 6'6", 267. It's a first down at 39 for the Thundering Herd. Terrell Edwards-May, a sophomore from Mobile, comes in and picks up a yard. And you mentioned him, Cody Slate, really one of the best tight ends going, and was a semifinalist for the Mackey Award, even though he had torn that ACL.
Yeah, against Southern Miss in week 10, and he has 199 career catches, 23 of them for touchdowns. They used to move him all around and really feature him in the passing game of their offense. He's a good blocker. I think he's a Sunday player.
The best tight end statistically in the history of Marshall. Anderson rolls out, finds his target for another first down. That is junior Chuck Walker, picked up 11.
They love to move Brian Anderson to the edges in terms of just creating a problem for the pass rush. And he is so good at throwing on the run. He can go both ways. This time, you know, the easy way to his right. And you see he threw it right between the 8 and the 4 of Walker.
Marshall with another first down. Now into Ohio territory at their 49. Ward in the backfield gets the handoff and goes up the right side to pick up about 3 yards. Lee Renfro, another of the active linebackers for Ohio, made the stop.
And Martin Ward has a nice future here at Marshall, I think. Just a redshirt freshman, but when he had to play when Darius Marshall was out injured, he had 136 yards against Southern Methodist, who just spanked Nevada in that bowl game, which was just shocking to me, but yet showed you that Conference USA is a good brand of football.
Second and 7 now for Marshall. Darius Marshall back in the backfield. Anderson fakes it to him. Here comes the blitz. And Anderson keeping the play alive. The coaches say he's just athletic enough to escape pickles like that one. He did that time and got close to another first down.
and he loves to move up and forward into the pocket. That's his initial escape move, and he got away from Zach Notestein, excuse me, Dak Notestein, and he saw he can make plays with his feet as well. Just not a, you know, he's not going to go out the other end, but he does have a nice knack for moving around and a good feel for his pocket.
Coaches really like his demeanor. They say he's always even keeled, never too high, never too low. Good demeanor for a quarterback.
Previous play is under further review.
Can only assume they're looking at the spot. It was marked a first down.
They're going to, you're right, Pam, they're going to check and see if the knee went down before he extended the ball out to get the first down. And in looking at the replay, I think the knee stays up. You see, there's the yellow line, and they're looking at the left knee to see if that hit the ground before he goes out. Needed to get to the 39 for the first down. You see the knee right here. Hard to tell from that particular angle, but it looks to me like he stayed up off the ground with the knee, and it should be the play should stand as called on the field. And they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this, and I don't believe we saw that. And our replay official is Ken Lushito. He's looking at that thing upstairs. We also have the company of Jim Blackwood, the supervisor of the WAC officials, up in the booth with us today in case things get out of hand. Jim's going to help us out.
And that is the referee, Robert Cameron. To Cameron's right, that is the line judge, Sarah Thomas. There you see her. And yes, it's a her.
Yeah, she's the first woman, female, to do a bowl game. And I had the honor of my partner, Pam Ward, being the first woman to ever call a college bowl game. Your first one, what, back 2001?
In 2000.
Right here, right?
After further review, the runner was down before reaching the line of game, about 1/2 yard. It'll be 3rd and 1/2 yard.
So they reversed it, took him just under 2 minutes, so it'll be 3rd and a very short one. So yeah, Sarah Thomas, who's been a Conference USA official, sort of a fill-in as a line judge. She's a mom from Mississippi and loves football, and she says it's really no big deal. It's just something that she's really enjoyed doing, and obviously she's doing a good job of it to get a bowl game.
Yeah, I think it's great, Pam, that women are getting opportunities, and the opportunity that you have, and you've proved over the years that you are more than qualified and just one of the best, in my opinion, play-by-play announcers in all of college football, and it's been a pleasure working with you these last 3 years.
Oh, Darius Marshall busting loose on a 3rd and 1. Marshall gets the first down by a ton, so the reversal obviously did not hurt them. Darius picked up 17.
Well, great blocking by the left side of the line. You see big number 78, Brandon Campbell, collapsing the line. Marshall sees the little crack to the outside. Lee Smith threw a block as well, and that's all Darius Marshall needs. You see how quickly he can explode up through a hole.
Doesn't seem like that ankle injury hurt him at all. One good thing about the bowl week, they had time to rest, missed the last two games of the regular season. Anderson with a throwback to Smith, and the big tight end breaks a tackle and lunges forward. Lee Renfro had a chance to get him.
And this is really a great play by Lee Renfro, although he did miss the tackle. But he stays home and he stays disciplined. Here's Renfro right here, and here's the tight end Smith. And watch how he's got Smith man-to-man. See how he stays out there with him and then makes the immediate pressure, slows things down, and that allows the hustling Bobcat defense to get over there.
If Renfro could have wrapped him up, they would have lost 7 yards, but that was a backward pass, so technically a rush for Smith, and he gained nothing on it. Here's a 2nd and 10. 10th play of this drive for Marshall. Darius Marshall carries a couple of Bobcats with him inside the 20. Marcellus Williamson, who weighs in at about 342 pounds, made the stop on Marshall. There's the big guy.
Yeah, he's one of two big guys on this Ohio defense. He and Ernie Hodge, 300-plus pounders. They hold down the middle there, but the rest of this defense is undersized, but they have great speed. So those two guys hold that point of attack, and everybody else flies around, and they are very ball-conscious, scrappy, ball-hawking type guys with the speed to get to the ball. That's why they have so many takeaways.
First time either team has been in the red zone today. Marshall 2-for-2 on third downs in this drive, including converting on a 3rd and 16. Anderson converts on another one. Chuck Walker grabs it right before he went out of bounds.
Number 12, Thad Turner, has the coverage. He gives too big of a cushion. And right there, you see the foot is definitely in. And Antavius Wilson extends the ball past the yard to make. And it's another third down conversion for the Thundering Herd.
Chuck Walker, the junior from Oakland, coming up with another catch. This drive, Ray, now over 7 minutes in length. Martin Ward in the backfield on first down from the 13. Ward gets it, big hole right up the middle, and he keeps going.
Tried to get through there.
He squirts out of what looked like a sure play-ending tackle. Marshall, with a huge drive, strikes first.
Oh, what a great run by Ward. You're going to see him kind of get caught up in the middle there, and then the safety, number 20, Patrick Tafua, comes up and he drops his head and misses the tackle. He broke four tackles on that play, did Martin Ward, to get into the end zone. That's a heck of an individual effort.
That is his second touchdown of the season. Britannamorn in for the extra point. A 12-play, 79-yard drive that ate up over almost 7.5 minutes. Cap it off with a touchdown run by Ward.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
All right, so you're driving down the freeway doing about 60 when you notice the guy next to you is steering with his knees, eating a cheeseburger, and talking on the phone. And that is exactly why the Ford F-150 is the safest truck in America. It's got a high-strength steel safety cage, side impact airbags, safety canopy, 5-star crash rating, and roll stability control. Because it's not just crazy out there, it's certifiably insane, okay? It's not just a pickup truck. It's a Ford F-150.
A Monday night battle from the black and blue division, Coach.
It's time to pound a rock.
Intense NFC North rivals meet for a Monday night slugfest.
Brett Favre and the Vikings are fighting for prime playoff position.
But Jay Cutler and the Bears will be on the prowl for an upset.
Can the division champs get back on track, or will Chicago bear down for a Windy City win?
ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings Bears at 8:30.
People who have been diagnosed with mesothelioma have many questions. How did I get this disease? What are my treatment options? How will this affect my loved ones? You need answers, which is why we offer a free book written by medical professionals who have treated mesothelioma.
Call toll-free 1-888-888-3231 or go to freemesobook.com.
There's no obligation, so call toll-free at 1-888-888-3231.
More cash over here.
It's much easier to find money at Esurance. Great auto insurance rates and lots of discounts.
Got insurance already? Save more with Esurance's Switch and Save discount.
It also pays to shop online. You get Esurance's Fast 5 discount just for getting an instant online quote.
Thanks, Professor.
Don't forget the good student discount.
And there's even more discounts.
It's no secret that you can save hundreds with Esurance.
Make it your mission to click or call Esurance today.
Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tonight with the Emerald Bowl. Montel Harris leads Boston College against Pete Carroll's USC Trojans. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN and ESPN360.com tonight at 8 Eastern time. That game coming to you from beautiful San Francisco. We are in Detroit, where Thundering Herd fans have traveled yet again. This team was here, made several stops when this game was played in Pontiac, when it was known as the Motor City Bowl. This is the first year that it's the Little Caesars Bowl, and we are at Ford Field, where the Lions play. Tana Moore kicks it off to Harden for Ohio. And he gets bunched up right at the 17-yard line. Let's go back to the score, Ray.
Yeah, this is an interesting touchdown. You're going to see right there is the guard, and he is going to pull to this side. And now look how many guys they're going to have over on this side of the football. They've outnumbered him. They got six guys over there. Here's the guy who's going to have a chance to make the play because they've got a hat for a hat for everybody else. They're outnumbered. They have nobody for the safety, Patrick Tafua, but he drops his head. Ward makes him miss, and then there he goes into the end zone. And I'll tell you who isn't happy about that is Marcellus Williamson because he got pulled out of the game prior to that touchdown. And he's their beef, and they need a big guy in the middle if they're going to stop that running game.
They converted three third downs on that 79-yard, 12-play drive. Scott picks it up, flings it out to Terrence McCray, and he is boarded out of bounds. Picked up 3 yards. And boy, that drive by Marshall, I mean, you think about it, it almost had disaster written all over it. They are backed up towards their goal line. They were facing a third and 16. So that really could have been a huge swing. Ohio, if they could have forced the punt, would have gotten it in great field position. But instead, it's 7-0 Marshall.
Yeah, Brian Anderson hung in there on a third and 16. Found Lee Smith over the middle to keep that thing alive. And they kind of just took the momentum of that play and parlayed it into a touchdown drive.
First time that we have seen Ohio with four receivers. They really love this receiving core. Scott has things break down around him. He's a good improviser, and that pass was incomplete, intended for Vince Davidson.
That's what Theo Scott does best, in my opinion, is he just makes things happen when things break down. Here it is. You're going to see the pressure coming from the outside from Mario Harvey, who's coming on a blitz. Scott just dumps inside of that, tries to make a play at the end. He's not able to connect with Vince Davidson, but it just shows you the ability that Scott has to keep things alive and make something out of nothing.
Brings up a third and 7. For the Bobcats, they're 0-for-2 so far on third down conversions. Here comes the blitz, and that pass is well over the head of the intended receiver, McCray. Scott had to get rid of it in a hurry with the blitz coming from Omar Brown, safety. So 2-3 and outs in the first three possessions for Ohio.
Here goes the blitz. You're going to see it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 men coming. Scott. Feels the pressure, and that forces the quick throw, and he just overthrew his receiver, who was open. Just got to settle down a little bit, but he is a kind of a cool character. They love him. They think he's done a great job taking over the leadership for Frank Solich's football team.
Hershey's third punt pressed into action today. Andre Booker, a very exciting true freshman, breaks free down the sideline. Nobody's going to catch him. Touchdown, Marshall, on the punt return.
Yards to the house for the freshman Andre Booker. There was some questioning of Mark Snyder when he was the head coach of why did they burn the red shirt on Booker, and the day after they questioned him, he went out there and had two huge punt returns in that ball game. So he answered those criticisms, and you can see why he's out there playing as a true freshman right now. That was an explosive return by Booker.
A career-long 58-yard punt return. First touchdown for him as a punt returner. Marshall exploding in the last couple of minutes of the first quarter to take a 14-0 lead. We talked about the Ohio return men, how explosive they were coming into this game, but it's Andre Booker who takes it in for the Marshall score.
ESPN360.com, where to watch when you can't watch.
All right, the commercial's on, so you're probably halfway to the fridge. So I'm going to talk loud. Save your appetite for dinner, which I'm about to save you money on. Get to your computer and type in littlecaesars.com. You know what you'll see there? A coupon that gets you a large hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. You heard me right, $3.99. Today and tomorrow only, and only with coupons. A large hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. The best value in America just got better. How's that for appetite appeal?
Pizza, pizza.
Announcing the Lincoln Wishlist sales event. With short-term 27-month leases on the latest in luxury and technology. But hurry to the Lincoln Wishlist sales event because these special 27-month leases will be gone soon. Now, lease a Lincoln MKZ for 27 months for only $329 a month. During the Lincoln Wishlist sales event at your Lincoln Mercury dealer.
It's a revolution in pain relief.
The new Icy Hot Medicated Roll. Take what you need for shoulders, backs, joints, even arthritis. Medicated Relief gets icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. The new Icy Hot Medicated Roll.
With the roll, pain's under control.
Tailgating isn't an event. It's an art. You got to get here early if you want to get a good spot. You got to think about things like the sun, the wind direction. Things the rookies never think of, but we veterans know. You need at least two or three meat varieties, a couple different drinks, no vegetables. You know, if I'm going to do something, I'm going to do it right. Same with taking care of the truck that gets me here. That's why I use Napa parts. Is it too early for a brat?
An ordinary man in a race against time.
Just come to Hard Ride North on Alvarado.
He has the information.
Somebody's one step ahead of us. How's that possible?
Where's he going?
He has the tools.
Where's he heading?
But most of all, he has AT&T, the nation's fastest 3G network. Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate. Only from AT&T.
There's a time and place for them. The time is never. You can figure out the place on your own. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Is a haircut a job hunting expense?
Last summer, my kid made four figures. Does he need to file a tax return?
They're not just any questions.
Did we just make a charitable donation?
They're the trickiest, thorniest questions of all.
Is this considered a home office?
Bring your tax question to the company that helped clients get over $43 billion in refunds last year alone.
How can I get more money?
Click, call, or come over. H&R Block. Get it right.
Welcome back to Detroit for the Little Caesars Bowl. Marshall with two touchdowns in a minute 17-second span at the end of the first quarter, and they are up two scores on Ohio. And there's Andre Booker, 5'10", true freshman out of Sarasota, who just busted back 58 yards for the touchdown on a punt return to close out the first quarter. Pam Ward and Ray Bentley joining you from Detroit. Tana Moore, who has a couple of extra points, kicks it off and through the end zone. Ohio down 14-0, takes over from the 20. Let's head back to Booker's magic on the punt return.
Well, he does this initial part. You're going to see him catch the ball. He's going to get past the initial wave right here. Then he uses the speed, just the pure speed. Right there, hold it. You see, here's the good block that he got from Jordan Taylor. That allows him to get the edge, and he just outruns everybody on the Bobcat defense. And Booker with the first Marshall return, punt return for a touchdown since 2000.
Nobody touched him as he took it down the far sideline for the score. Marshall team led by interim head coach Rick Minter, who had been their defensive coordinator the last couple of years, up 14-0 on the Bobcats. Let's see what Theo Scott and company can do. Scott fakes it and then hangs on to it. Picks up three on first down. Omar Brown with the stop. This Ohio offense has sputtered at times during the season, and they're sputtering so far today, Ray.
Well, you look at it, two of their possessions have ended up in three and outs. They are just still searching for something that's going to work against this Marshall defense, which is a very stout defense. They kind of crumbled late in the year, but they were put into some bad situations, you know, with field position and things of that nature. But when they were playing good ball early in the year, it was because of this defense.
Ohio's offense, meanwhile, in the bottom of most MAC statistical categories on offense. There's a nice completion to Jordan Thompson, the tight end, who picks up the Bobcat first down. We have a late flag in the offensive backfield and a hurt Marshall player. Boy, that's Vinny Curry holding on to his knee.
Hate to see that, especially in a bowl game situation. Take a look and see what happened to him. Oh, he just got hit late.
Personal
in
foul,
the play.
Number 76 of the offense. Hitting a player out of the play.
I don't see that as a personal foul. Kadri Pender just gave him a little shove as he was running back to the ball. Not a necessary hit, but certainly not a cheap shot. And, you know, you play to the whistle, you keep going. You just give the guy a little push. I don't know that that should have been a personal foul, but the result was horrible.
So Curry on the field. He is second to Mario Harvey in sacks for Marshall this year. You saw his leg planted and the knee buckled. Let's set it to the studio now for a Flomax ball update.
Oh, yeah.
Dari Noka in studio. Time for your bowl update presented by Flomax. And so far this bowl season has really had a Mountain West Conference kind of feel. Three teams have played in bowl games. The first was Wyoming in double overtime. Austin Carter Samuels, the touchdown pass, and the Cowboys knock off Fresno State. How about the Mako Bowl, Las Vegas, BYU, Max Hall to Dennis Pitta. They are brothers-in-law, and they connect there. BYU knocks off Oregon State. How about more Mountain West over the Pac-10? How about Utah using offense and defense to knock off Cal? 3-0 this bowl season for the Mountain West Conference, and two of the three wins coming against Pac-10 teams. That's your bowl update presented by Flomax. Back to Detroit after this.
They're running the men's room marathon
with lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the men's room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right. Those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
Critics and audiences agree, Invictus is great entertainment. And now it's been nominated for 3 Golden Globe Awards. Best Actor, Morgan Freeman. Best Supporting Actor, Matt Damon. And Best Director, Clint Eastwood.
This is our destiny!
Invictus, rated PG-13.
You value your friends. So does DirecTV. Bob's worth 100. So are Carrie, Ann, and Sue. For every friend you refer to DirecTV, you get $100. And they get $100 on top of our new customer offer. Just give your account number to your friends and have them call 1-877-4-100 each. They must have your account number when they order. This offer's only good for a limited time, so hurry. Then celebrate and watch the Benjamins stack up.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any 4 movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
Through a night we'll never forget.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any 4 movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
Welcome back to Detroit. Kadri Pender's personal foul negates an Ohio first down. It happened during the play, so it's second down. They take it half the distance to the goal line to the 12. Second and 18 for the Bobcats. Scott on the roll, throws it out beyond the outstretched fingertips of LaVon Brazil.
Let's go back to that play, and you're going to see right there at the bottom of your screen He gets hit by number 76, Cadre Pender, and that's Vinnie Curry obviously taking the hit. But the rule is a point of emphasis for the officials. And Jim Blackwood, our supervisor from the WAC, who's up here in the booth with us, showed me the actual rule book, and I'm reading out of this. And it's to protect defenseless players. And it says the player who is obviously out of the play, which is the case with Curry. That's why the flag was called. A good call in that regard.
Curry was helped off the field, nursing a left leg injury. Scott to the sideline to Bussey, and that play is well covered. Picked up about 6 yards. Brandon Burns making the stop, and here comes another Bobcats punt.
Boy, they finally thought they had a little something going, Pam, and the penalty cost them. Four possessions and just 41 yards and only 2 first downs. Not a good start for Coach Solich's offense.
All 4 possessions ending with Paul Hershey punts. Booker, who took the last punt he touched back for a touchdown, is back. And this is Hershey's style, more of a rugby style kicker. But that's a heck of a punt on the run. Ashton Hall back there, but we have contact and flags come down. That was a 52-yard punt by Hershey, his second 50-yarder today. In there because Matt Schulte, the regular punter, the first team punter, is not here because of a violation of team policy.
And I think this is going to be catch interference against the Bobcats. They did not give the return man, Ashton Hall, a chance to really make a play on the football.
Interference, number 37 of the kicking team. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Isa Braithwaite is the one who is guilty of making this infraction. Watch him, he's gonna get right up on Hall. And you see he gets there before the ball does. Great call by the officials. You gotta give that guy, in this case, Ashton Hall, the chance to make a play on the football. Doesn't do it, major penalty, and Marshall will have pretty decent starting field position after that excellent punt.
In fact, it is marked initially at the 44. And now they're gonna put it, it looks like, just past the 45-yard line. So Frank Solich's team not off to a great start, trailing 14-0 to Marshall, that scored 2 touchdowns in the last minute 17 of the first quarter. Ohio with 4 punts on 4 possessions. And Marshall has the football back. Booker, who had the touchdown on the punt return, picks up a couple. He's one of these guys that they really could put him just about anywhere on the field. They can use him in a variety of ways with his skill set.
And his speed, that's the main thing. That one that took, I think the timing was off as far as the snap to the handoff. It just took too long. Noah Keller made that tackle. He was the backside inside linebacker. He had the time to run all the way across the field and match speed with Booker to make the tackle.
Brings up a 2nd and 8. And Anderson completes it to Antavius Wilson. Picked up about 8 yards, and they mark it right at the first down stick.
That Turner is giving Wilson a huge cushion up top. And Marshall can just take this anytime they want. Look at that distance, that the respect that Turner is giving Antavius Wilson. And until they close that down, that's an option for Marshall to pick up 7, 8, 10 yards anytime they want.
Wilson, just a redshirt freshman. The coaches, including John Shannon, offensive coordinator, said he's just going to get better as he kind of grows into his body a little bit, gets into the weight room, and that should help his speed. Darius Marshall only got about 1 yard on that carry. He was 2nd, was Antavius Wilson to Cody Slade in catches and yards per game, but Slade out for the year with the torn ACL, so Wilson's number 1.
And he made the all-freshman Conference USA team, and deservedly so, and he really emerged, especially as a deep threat in their play-action game, which we haven't seen yet. I'm sure they're getting close to winging one deep down the field off of play-action. They love to do that.
2nd and 9 for the Thunder and Herd. And Anderson quickly gets rid of it, and he finds Wilson yet again, and Tavius breaks a couple of tackles and picks up 5 more yards for Marshall.
This is just a runoff play. They're going to run every receiver deep except for Antavius Wilson, who's going shallow under the middle. It pulls the linebackers back. Renfro reacted to it but missed the tackle, allowing a few extra yards.
Third and 4 as Anderson looks over. John Shannon in his second season as the Marshall offensive coordinator. The entire program waiting for Doc Holliday to take over as the head coach.
Yeah, a lot of uncertainty when you're in that situation. You don't know if you're going to be retained, or are you going to have to look for a job? Is your family going to have to move? All those things.
Third down, and Wilson catches another one. Anderson and Wilson making a nice combination on this drive, pick up another first down.
Anderson is outstanding when they roll the pocket out, which they love to do, but he's going to his left here. See how he gets the shoulders and the hips square to the line of scrimmage? That allows him to throw the football, and he finds Wilson, who just finds that little hole, that little window in the flowing defense, and they're able to hook up for the first down.
Anderson missed his first pass, but since then he is 7 for 7 for 62 yards. First down from the 33. Anderson sticking in the air, gets hit as he released it. The ball is thrown short, and there are flags down. Will this be offensive pass interference? Walker got tangled up with Shannon Ballard.
Lee Renfro made a nice move, beating the block of Terrell Edwards May.
Pass interference on the 22 defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot.
And he put the pressure on Brian Anderson, but it's going to be Shannon Ballard who's going to be called for this interference, and you can see it right there at the end. Yeah, he just got in front of Chuck Walker. Here's the pressure. There's Renfro finishing things off. Nice hit on the quarterback. You love that when you're a linebacker, if you can put your face in his chest and put him on the back of the turf a little bit. But the play down the field, Shannon Ballard did not find the football. And if you don't find the football, odds are you're going to get to that receiver too soon, and you're going to cause yourself a problem with a penalty.
The contact against Walker makes it a first down from the 18-yard line. Second straight trip into the red zone for Marshall. The last time it resulted in a touchdown run by Martin Ward. Ward gets it again. Renfro makes a stop 5 yards downfield. So any question of how Marshall would come out with, as Ray mentioned, a whole program in flux with Rick Minner wanted to be the head coach, threw his hat in the ring even though he knew it would be a long shot. And you have to, I mean, we were very impressed talking to Minner on the phone leading up to this, and he's handled it very well, and his team seems to be handling it very well.
Yeah, when we talked to him, Pam, you got a great sense of the fact that he was going to have this team focused and ready to play.
They have looked 100% ready to play. Here's Ohio showing the blitz and backing off a little bit. Noah Keller sticks his nose up in there again, and Darius Marshall runs right by him down to the 4-yard line for another first down.
That's a great cutback by Darius Marshall. Watch how he keeps his shoulders square the line of scrimmage, and that allows him to be able to make that cutback move that he wants if it displays itself. And that's 13 cutback yards now for Darius Marshall, as you see the dominance in particular in the time of possession here for this Marshall football team.
Knocking on the door again, first and goal from the 5. Marshall's still in the backfield. And Ohio calls timeout.
Timeout, Ohio.
Rick Minner's team has it going, threatening to go up by 3 scores. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN Sunday night. More football coming your way. Derek Locke and Kentucky take on the ever-exciting C.J. Spiller and the Clemson Tigers. That's the Gaylord Hotels Music City Bowl from Nashville. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN and ESPN360.com Sunday at 8:30 Eastern Time. And there you see Kentucky. What a great job for that football program now in four straight bowls. And C.J. Spiller can pretty much score every time he touches the football.
He's something else. He'll get you from anywhere on the field at any given time.
Returns as a running back. They put him out as a receiver sometimes, so you don't want to miss Kentucky and Clemson coming your way tomorrow. Meanwhile, Marshall knocking on the door of another score, forced Ohio to burn its second timeout. Three tight ends in for the Thunder and Herd. Darius Marshall in at running back. Marshall right up the middle. Stacked up a couple yards downfield by the middle of that Bobcat defense. Donovan Fletcher coming up to make the stop from his safety spot. And we look down there and we see big number 62, Marcellus Williamson, is in this time close to the goal line.
Right, he did a pretty good job on that play. Ate up about three blockers with the penetration that he had. But Darius Marshall was able to get to the second level. And again, Ohio running bodies in and out of that defensive lineup down here in this area of the field.
Now second and goal. Marshall doesn't get close. He is stopped at the 2-yard line by Noah Keller. Comes away with the football. You saw him digging in there trying to get the ball away from Darius, but the whistle and play had been blown dead.
Yeah, Keller ripped at it about three times. He finally did get it, but it was called dead. You see Renfro is going to go in and get the first hit, just trips him up. And then when Keller shows up, he says, I'm going to try and get me that ball. One rip, two rips. And the third rip, bam, he finally gets it out. But the play was already dead. The whistle is blown.
And again, Ohio, the most proficient team in forcing turnovers this year. 36 on the season, but none today. Here's a third and goal from the two. Ward has two touchdowns. Went in from 12 last time out. This time he takes it in from two.
Boy, great job by Chris Bowers, the center, along with Campbell, the tackle, and just paving the way. But Chris Bowers, the freshman, getting his first start ever with the Thundering Herd, and he knocked big Marcellus Williamson, 350 pounds of him. He knocked him 2 yards off the ball, and that created the room for the Martin Ward touchdown.
Another impressive drive. They had one of over 7 minutes, and this went 5:45. Rotana Moore in for his third extra point. The Thundering Herd trying to finish the season with a winning record for the first time in 5 years, off to a terrific start. Ward has a couple of touchdowns, 21-0 Herd.
You want to score a deal on dinner? Then listen up, because this play is money. Everybody, cut right to your computer and type in LittleCaesars.com. Print the coupon there, and you get a large, freshly made, hot and ready pizza for an incredible $3.99. $3.99? This place is going wild, but it's good for 2 days only, so the clock is running. Get to Little Caesars with your coupon and seal the deal tonight.
Pizza, pizza.
Lady, get out!
Hey, lady. This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
Announcing the Lincoln Wishlist sales event. With short-term 27-month leases on the latest in luxury and technology. But hurry to the Lincoln Wishlist sales event, because these special 27-month leases will be gone soon. Now, lease a Lincoln MKZ for 27 months for only $329 a month during the Lincoln Wishlist sales event at your Lincoln Mercury dealer.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu. good to be back.
You get a lot of different stuff from her, and it's all right here. Everything sent to you, organized by the person who sent it. The Droid Heiress. The droid that's as connected as you. Exclusively at Verizon Wireless.
ESPN College Football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by Little Caesars Pizza, home of the large, hot and ready pizza. Always fresh, always ready. Capital One, what's in your wallet? And the Ford F-150. It's not just a pickup truck, it's a Ford F-150.
Part of the fun of going to a bowl game is they let you have fun. That's in Auburn Hills, north of Detroit. Both teams went to GameWorks where they blew off some steam. And those Marshall fans, boy, are they ever ready. Up 21-0.
Yeah, they are just mauling the Ohio defense. You know, I thought coming in they had an advantage there in that situation, and they've been able to pound them with that. And then the Ohio offense has yet to find something that'll work. And when they do get a play, they've had penalties that have brought it back.
Two touchdown drives, eating up 13 minutes of clock time. Plus, Marshall has a punt return for a touchdown by Andre Booker. Here's Chris Garrett, a very good kick returner for Ohio. See if he can get something going. Loses the ball at the end of the play, but they say he was down at the 29-yard line. Brought it back 27 yards, tackled by Ashton Hall. Here's some news and notes as we are full swing into Capital One Bowl Week. A terrific start for the Mountain West. Boy, Utah always wins whenever they go to a bowl. And how about June Jones going home to Hawaii and just smacking Nevada around?
Yeah, I was really surprised that Nevada didn't really come ready to play that game. And, of course, we've got the Meineke Car Care Bowl and the Emerald Bowl coming up later on today. A great day to sit there in front of the television, your favorite beverage, and just kind of relax and bowl out.
Best thing to do this time of year, day after Christmas, everybody's settling in. Let's see what Ohio can do on offense. The answer so far has been not much, but here's Theo Scott. He had to run a long way to pick up about 4 yards. Daquan Bembry, credit him with the tackle.
Yeah, and this Marshall defense is just too fast. So you see Scott just coming on a speed option straight to the edge. I think at that point he would have been better off just lowering his head and getting upfield and diving for a few more. As it was, I think he lost a yard or two when he went lateral, as the speed of the Marshall Thundering Herd was too much for him.
Brings up a 2nd and 6. Scott has everybody covered downfield and then dumps it to a safety valve man and Dante Harden. Great defense from Marshall. Coming into this game, there was a lot of attention on the Ohio wide receivers, but the Thundering Herd have done a terrific job of keeping them really out of the game.
Well, initially, he wants to go up here and throw the ball on this side to his tight end to get something going on out there. You see the receiver was late getting off the ball. It's totally covered. Look at all the coverage of the Marshall defenders. There is nowhere for Theo Scott to throw the football. And so he runs around for a while. He finally does dump it off, but the Thundering Herd, very athletic on defense, close it down quickly.
Price, Brazil, McCray, three of the top receivers, have 3 catches between them today. Scott loses the football. He had it stripped. Marshall has everything going its way. The Thundering Herd recover it at the 22-yard line. Janik forced it. And McClellan came up with it, Ray.
Again, nowhere for Theo Scott to throw the football. You see him, the old tuck rule deal. He brings it down. Janik is there. And the Marshall defense playing extremely well. He wanted LaVon Brazil. And you see number 7 right there on the ground sliding across. He got whacked by Mario Harvey. And that was the guy that Theo Scott wanted to throw it to. Just a little dump off over the middle. Oh, man, did Mario Harvey just totally knock out LaVon Brazil. Nowhere for Theo Scott to go. The pocket collapses, and Coach Solich is trying to state a case over there. I don't think he's got one.
Marshall comes up with the first turnover of the football game. That's been Ohio's bread and butter. But they have not been able to get the football away from the Thundering Herd, and Marshall is sitting pretty right now. First down from the 22. They've had two very impressive touchdown drives that have eaten up a combined 13 minutes. And then the punt return to go up 21-0, and here they are knocking on the door again.
This Marshall offense balanced about how I thought they would be. 17 runs for 73 yards, 8 passes for 62 yards, just one incompletion on the day for Anderson.
Please check the stands and make sure that nobody in the stands is using a whistle, please.
And they're hearing a whistle from somebody in the stadium. And that's what Coach Solich was complaining about. He says, my guys hear a whistle, they stop. And I certainly can empathize with them. You better put your whistle away, Pam.
Will do. First down for Marshall after the turnover. Ryan Anderson under center gives it to Darius Marshall, his star running back, flag down, and the ball is loose. Picked up by Shannon Ballard. Ballard takes it all the way in. The question is, will it stand because of the penalty mark?
If it stands, it's a 75-yard return for Shannon Ballard, and the opportunistic defense that got Ohio here got it done again as Jeff King forced the fumble. Ballard picks it up and goes, but we'll see what that flag was all about. Usually when it's thrown in that area, it's an offensive infraction.
On the offense, there's the coin.
Ballard's fumble return for a touchdown holds. And as you mentioned, Ray, this really has been Ohio football all year. And boy, did they need it right then. Marshall about, you know, they score then, it could be 28-0, and the game would be all but over.
Right. This is one of those momentum changers. And Frank Solich's teams have come back in three games trailing in the fourth quarter to win. So they know how to hang around and then capitalize on mistakes. And they forced that one right there.
Leading the nation now with 37 forced turnovers. Matt Weller adds the extra point, a huge turnaround for the Bobcats.
Maybe that'll be what Ohio needs to get woken up as Shannon Ballard, 75 yards out the gate. Marshall still leads by 14.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
All right, so you're driving down the freeway doing about 60 when you notice the guy next to you is steering with his knees, eating a cheeseburger, and talking on the phone. And that is exactly why the Ford F-150 is the safest truck in America. It's got a high-strength steel safety cage, side impact airbags, safety canopy, 5-star crash rating, and roll stability control. Because it's not just crazy out there, it's certifiably insane. It's not just a pickup truck. It's a Ford F-150.
Shoot, do it. Let's go, Brian. Shoot, do it.
On the air and behind the scenes, SportsCenter.com covers the people, headlines, and highlights that have the sports world buzzing.
A Monday night battle from the black and blue division, Coach. It's time to pound a rock.
Brett Favre and the Vikings fight for prime playoff position against the Bears. ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings-Bears at 8:30.
Is your house one big doggy bathroom? The American Kennel Club presents the Potty Patch. Now dogs have a safe place to relieve themselves. No more spots on the carpet, stains on your hardwood, and mishaps on the couch. Watch as we pour a full quart of water right on the potty patch. It disappears, leaving the synthetic grass high and dry. The elevated turf drains into the base, keeping it odor-free. At the end of the day, just pour out the liquid. It's that easy. Order your AKC Potty Patch for just $39.99. Call right now and we'll upgrade your order for free. You'll receive our plush deluxe potty patch made of antimicrobial odor-resistant turf, a $60 value. Call now and keep your rugs, floors, and furnishings looking like new. Potty Patch, just $39.99.
Call 1-800-610-4692 to order your potty patch for only $39.99 plus shipping and handling. Call 1-800-610-4692. That's 1-800-610-4692. Call now.
Sunday night, don't miss an NFC North battle at Soldier Field. Brett Favre, Adrian Peterson, and the Vikings roll into Chicago to take on the Bears. Vikings-Bears, Monday Night Football on ESPN at 8:30 Eastern. Coverage starts with Monday Night Countdown served by Applebee's at 7 Eastern time. That Minnesota offense has been bogged down the last few games.
Yeah, what happened to the Favre magic? Saving it for the playoffs.
Vikings fans can only hope so.
Yeah.
Andre Booker has a punt return for a touchdown, takes the kickoff back to the 29-yard line. Let's go back to that fumble that led to Ohio's first score.
Yeah, and you're going to see, here's the hold right there by the center, Chris Bowers, and that's what the flag was all about. And then number 98, Jeff King, pops that ball out of there. You see it pop up into the air, and then Ballard fields the nice little Sunday hop right into his lap. Nobody near him. He's off to the races, and Ohio has gotten back into this ball game when things weren't going so well, and that's what they've done all year. You see the nine now non-offensive touchdowns, second only behind Texas with 11. That's what the Bobcats have fed on throughout the season. We'll see if that wakes them up, gets them playing a little better.
Only Texas has more non-offensive touchdowns. The Longhorns going to play a national championship game against Alabama in a couple of weeks. Timeout taken. Brian Anderson, the Marshall quarterback, burns his team's first timeout.
Looked like the play clock was running down, and Anderson had to quickly avert a 5-yard penalty there.
Rick Minter and the defensive coordinator. 10 years as a head coach at Cincinnati, then was relieved of his duties a couple of now coaches ago for Cincinnati. His future very much up in the air, but very gracious, has handled this very well. Would have loved to have been the head coach. So he really wants to be a head coach again, but would be also happy if he was in a good position as a defensive coordinator. But he really thinks that he's good as like a CEO kind of guy managing an entire program.
Yeah, and I think he has a track record of proving that. But you know, he was out of coaching in 2007 and living in Cincinnati, and Brian Kelly, the new Notre Dame coach, was the coach at Cincinnati, and he kind of reeled Rick Minter back in, brought him in, you know, had him made him be a little part of the program, and Rick was really grateful for Kelly in doing that.
Completion to Chuck Walker. He is taken down by Noah Keller. And the Ohio fans who have made the trip here to Detroit trying to get their defense to get another stop so maybe they could score again. And there are the OU fans. Again, Ohio has never won a bowl game. This is only their fourth bowl game in history, their second in 4 years. They had gone 38 years between bowls before Frank Solich got the head job.
And Frank has done an excellent job putting his stamp on this program and getting his kind of athletes involved. And one of those is Noah Keller, who already has 7 tackles in this game.
But there is a big breakout run for Martin Ward. He has a couple of touchdowns today, and that time we got to see his speed, 44 yards.
I was just telling everybody how great Darius Marshall is. Watch Ward hit this hole. He gets a little gap on the zone play. Nice block. Keller gets knocked out of the play by the guard, Rogers, and away he goes. And also Provancha in there making a nice block.
Gerald Moore with a touchdown-saving tackle. Terrell Edwards-May in for the follow-up carry. Lee Renfro made the stop for the Bobcats. So the Bobcat D looking good. And then Ward comes in with another run. He has a 12-yard touchdown run, a 2-yard touchdown run, and we just saw him break loose for 44 yards.
This Marshall football team has some very talented players. You can say what you want about Coach Mark Snyder. He did bring some good talent up into the Marshall football program. And I think Doc Holliday, the new coach, is going to be very excited. We'll talk to him in the third quarter.
Ward back in, got the carry and didn't pick up anything. Neil Wynn made the stop, the nose guard from Altoona, Pennsylvania.
Yeah, and Chris Bowers is center. Watch him get just blown back. And that's where the play is made right there. You see the penetration by Wynn. And, you know, Bowers, his first start, he's had some good, some bad so far. That's about what you would expect from a freshman starting his first game in a bowl game situation.
Chad Schofield out, injured. Honorable mention, Conference USA center not able to play today. Anderson breaking out, getting close to a first down. Shannon Ballard, who has a 75-yard fumble return for a touchdown for Ohio, made the stop. Looked like they marked him just short of the first down.
Yeah, that's a close one. They might have to measure this one. As Anderson continues, though, to give up the body. He got about four Bobcats take their shots at him. He saw him fall forward at the end, but they didn't give him the benefit of that.
Tip of the nose. Not a favorable spot for Marshall, but good enough for the first down.
Boy, see the shot that was taken there. Pretty nice work by the cameraman down on the sideline getting it done, and Brian Anderson getting it done down on the field. The junior starting for the first time in his career for this season. He has solidified that position. I think he's not necessarily a guy you ride the shoulders of, but he is more than adequate in getting it done.
8 for 9 through the air for 66 yards, and he ran for 7 yards on third down to pick up a first down and keep this drive going. Now the pitch to Darius Marshall. He is taken out of bounds. Only picked up about a yard on the play. Erica Jeeke making the stop, the senior from Tyler, Texas.
The herd went to an unbalanced line to the wide side of the field, trying to get that Bobcat defense to adjust, because that's how they scored their first touchdown, with that unbalanced line. And then they tried to get them this time by fooling them, running them back to that weak side. But Ajiki stayed and played his responsibility with great discipline. Big cushion up here.
But instead, they run it to Marshall right up the gut, and he is taken down at the 10. Noah Keller with yet another tackle. We have him unofficially with 8 stops in the first half. We hit the 2-minute mark. So here's another third down. What do you think Marshall does now?
Well, if I'm going to call this one, I'm John Shannon, the offensive coordinator, and I see that huge cushion, I'm going to throw the hitch or the out up top and just get the sticks. And you have it right up there again. That's where I would go. And now they're going to switch it up, coming to a press to take that away. A nice adjustment by the Bobcat defense.
And Tavius Wilson is split wide to the left. Anderson fakes it and hangs onto it. And does he run for another first down? He did earlier in this drive. He's marched close yet again.
Good hustle by the offensive line. Jimmy Rogers finishing the play. Watch him show up late right there and push the whole pile forward. That might have been enough to get the first down.
And that was the first time we saw an empty set back there. No running back for Marshall. So here it is, 4th and short, and they're going to go for it.
Probably quarterback sneak area.
Darius Marshall in the backfield. They pitch it backwards to Marshall.
I don't like that ever.
And he doesn't get it. In fact, he loses about a half yard or so. Noah Keller makes the stop. And I'm with you on that one, Ray. When you only need a little bit, why pitch it backwards?
Yeah, pitch it backwards and then run sideways. That defense is going to be ready for that. And Noah Keller, you can't fool him on that deal. And he comes up with a huge stop to turn the ball over on downs.
So the last couple of times that Marshall has gotten relatively close to the goal line, they have come up with no points. Ohio still in this game, down a couple of scores.
All right, the commercial's on, so you're probably halfway to the fridge. So I'm going to talk loud. Save your appetite for dinner, which I'm about to save you money on. Get to your computer and type in littlecaesars.com. You know what you'll see there? A coupon that gets you a large hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. You heard me right, $3.99. Today and tomorrow only, and only with coupons. A large hot ready pizza for just $3.99. The best value in America just got better. How's that for appetite appeal?
Pizza, pizza.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu, good to be back.
They lead across frozen rivers, from island to island, to build hope and carry on the ideals of a nation. Officers in the U.S. Army can rise to any challenge. They bring out the best in others and themselves. Can you? Start leading at goarmy.com/officer. There's strong, and then there's Army strong.
Hey, Tech! The only bull in your future is the one holding your chips!
Good one, little B.
I thought of that in the shower.
You actually paid money for this thing, Bergwood?
You're talking to me, dummy? Burn!
The more you save on insurance, the more you'll have for football. Drivers who switch from Geico to Allstate saved an average of $473 a year. Are you in good hands?
Closed captioning for selected programming is brought to you by Skechers.
New from Skechers, it's Shape Ups. Strengthen muscles, improve posture, reduce the impact on your joints and lower back with Shape Ups from Skechers.
Dari Noka in studio coming up in just a couple of minutes on the Cars.com halftime report. We're going to preview the Meineke Car Care Bowl, Pitt, North Carolina. Also, hear Pete Carroll's take on the status of tailback Joe McKnight as USC gets set for tonight's game against Boston College. And Trevor Madden's going to join us and talk about one of college football's most exciting quarterbacks, someone you may not know much about just yet. Pam and Ray.
Thank you very much, Dari. Looking forward to seeing you. Coming up with about 52 seconds of playing time left. All right, Ohio. Have the ball at the 4-yard line. They only have one timeout remaining. They have two first downs the entire first half. Safe to say they're just going to try to hope 52 seconds go by quickly.
Yeah, I don't know that you try and do anything crazy here. And if I'm Marshall, I'm going to use both those timeouts and force them to do something. Now they're in the pistol. Their two first downs have come out of the pistol formation, but they haven't run a ton of it here in the first half.
Theo Scott, the quarterback, gives it up to Chris Garrett, and he is tackled down in the end zone, but his forward progress marked out at the 3, so not even close to a safety. Good play by Kellen Harris.
Boy, if Theo Scott would have pulled this ball and ran, he could have been still going. You see the huge opening that he had. I think it was a called give, even though it looked like an option, as they're just trying to get a little room. Now the clock has stopped. Did Marshall use one of those timeouts?
Second charge.
Yes, they did.
First half.
Rick Minner hoping to get the ball back or at least force Ohio into a mistake. And, you know, it easily could be, or not easily, it could be 35-0 for Marshall. They've had two trips, their last two trips down inside the 30. They've come away with 0 points. 7 points for Ohio the other way on a fumble return for a touchdown. From coast to coast, you can now get the latest news on the teams you care about the most. The power of ESPN covering Boston, Chicago, Dallas, and now the Los Angeles sports scenes. News, opinion, and a special sports center just for your city. The inside information you're accustomed to now with local flavor. ESPNLosAngeles.com, ESPNChicago.com, ESPNBoston.com, and ESPNDallas.com. It is ranging all over the country.
Yeah, how about that? Can't wait till they get the Grand Rapids version.
You could run that, right?
Yeah, I'm there, I'm ready.
You're volunteering.
Holler at me.
A Marshall fan who took some time to dress up those shoulder pads. Garrett hanging on to it. Stopped just short of the 5, bringing up third down. James Burks with the stop. And another timeout. So this Ohio offense we have been mentioning, that they are not exactly the most dynamic offense in the world, to say the least. They've only had 9 rushing touchdowns all season, which is just staggering. That's 113th out of 120 teams in the country. And it's really bearing out with just 2 first downs so far today, Ray.
Yeah, and the 3 penalties, they have been costly penalties, negating first downs. And then give the credit to this Thundering Herd defense. They have been running and flying all over the field. And they are a big part of the reason for the lack of execution for Coach Solich's Bobcat offense.
Yep, the 7 points, not the defense's fault. It was on a fumble return for a touchdown. The 9th offensive or non-offensive touchdown scored by the Bobcats all year. Now they're going to take a knee. Smart decision this far down. Marshall can't stop it. They will take a 21-7 lead into the locker room. Rick Minter passed over as the head coach of Marshall, but boy, his team very much ready to play, leading Frank Solich's club 21-7. Halftime of the Little Caesars Bowl. Time for the Cars.com halftime report. Trevor Maddich and Dari Noka.
All right, Pam, Ray, thank you much. We'll send it back out to the Motor City for the second half in just a little bit. In the meantime, you get us, Dari Noka and Trevor Maddich. Oh, we were talking about the Ohio offense before we went to the game and how they do so many different things in misdirection. They are certainly misdirected. They never showed up, and that's a problem for the Bobcats so far.
Yeah, biggest direction is backwards, but yeah. It's less the Ohio offense than the Marshall defense. Mm. Rick Minter, the interim head coach, has got these guys focused. And that's no surprise because Minter is just taking over for the departed head coach of Marshall in the temporary basis. But he was the guy that really started building the foundation with the Cincinnati Bearcats. Then when he left, Mark D'Antonio elevated it more. And then we saw them with Brian Kelly do what they've done in the last 2 years. So Minter's been around and he knows what to do.
21-7, Marshall leading Ohio, a Bobcat program that's never won a bowl game. Not yet. Coming up, we look ahead to a couple of games today, Meineke Car Care Bowl, and focus on Deion Lewis and Pitt as they take on North Carolina. And Pete Carroll will discuss the status of Joe McKnight for USC as they take on Boston College this evening.
You're one of those multitaskers who wishes you could talk on the phone and surf the web at the same time. AT&T's 3G network lets you do that. Verizon's doesn't. Actually, you can talk on the phone and surf the web with Verizon, but you just need two phones to do it.
Yeah, I can.
Sorry. Can I give you a hand?
Thank you. Hello? Yeah. I'm still waiting for it to download.
When you compare, there's no comparison.
Yeah, I'm going to type it in again.
AT&T, a better 3G experience. This holiday, get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate.
Would you like a pony?
Yeah.
Would you like a pony?
Yeah.
Here you go. This is for you.
Wow, that's fun.
Yeah.
Well, you didn't say you could have a real one.
Well, you didn't ask.
Even kids know it's wrong to hold out on somebody. Why don't banks? We're Ally, a new bank that alerts you when your money can be working harder and earning more. It's just the right thing to do.
For the first time in history, more people live in cities than anywhere else.
Which means cities have to get smarter.
New York has smart crime fighting.
Paris has smart healthcare.
Smart traffic systems in Brisbane keep traffic moving.
Galway has smart water.
Smart meters in Dallas, Houston,
and a smart grid in Copenhagen keep energy flowing.
Smart ideas are happening
all over the world.
I want to bring them all together in your city.
A smart of Paris.
A smart of Stuttgart.
São Paulo.
Copenhagen.
Kyoto.
Planet of smarter cities.
That's what I'm working on.
I'm an IBMer.
Let's build a smarter planet.
Coach, you look great.
Wow, Coach, you really are back in the game.
I took your advice, Dad, and I lost 32 pounds on Nutrisystem. I feel great. So what are your numbers?
I lost 22 pounds, and I kept it off for 3 years.
Get back in the game in 2010. Order now, and you can get 2 weeks of meals free, plus the all-new Nutrisystem Jumpstart Kit, our secrets to ultimate weight loss.
Hey, you guys.
Boomer.
Well, thanks to you guys, I did go all the way.
Yep,
50 pounds lighter. So, Coach, how is the squad looking?
Best ever. You know, I have a real Hall of Famer at the helm.
LT?
Why not, Danny boy? I lost 35 pounds on Nutrisystem. Pieces, pastas, burgers, meats, come on, God, food is all you eat.
4 out of 5 men say Nutrisystem satisfies their hunger. Start your year off right. Order now, and you can get 2 weeks of meals free, plus the all-new Nutrisystem Jumpstart Kit.
Call or click today.
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
Pitt was oh so close to a BCS bowl game back on December 5th. It was Pitt and Cincinnati in the snow to determine who wins the Big East, and Deion Lewis had a big day, nearly 200 yards. He had 3 touchdowns. But after that touchdown, Pitt could not handle the extra point. That meant Tony Pike and Cincinnati would need 7 to win and go to a BCS game, which ends up being the Sugar Bowl. Cincinnati and Brian Kelly, although Kelly will not be there. That leaves Pitt facing North Carolina in the Meineke Car Care Bowl. To Charlotte we go.
Charlotte, North Carolina is NASCAR country. Players from Pitt and North Carolina trying to be the next Jimmy Johnson and Mark Martin, fine-tuning their engines, revving it up. Today it's all about college football, though, the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Quinn Kesnick along with Bob Greasy. And Bob, it's unusual in an era of spread offenses to see two pro-style offenses.
Well, I think you have to look at the two head coaches. Both of these coaches were under Jimmy Johnson. Both of them as defense comes first. They build their teams around defense. The strength of the defense is a defensive line. Offensively, we got to run the football and be physical. These two teams mirror each other.
I think any analysis of this game starts with Pitt, and where are they emotionally after a heartbreaking loss against Cincinnati?
Well, you forget, these are 18 to 22-year-old kids. That's been a month ago. That's long gone. They just don't want to end the season with a loss.
Pitt is led by one of the outstanding freshmen in college football, Deion Lewis, number 3 in the nation in rushing.
Last year, Deion Lewis was in high school, not knowing where he was going to go to school. He was only recruited by 3 teams, Pittsburgh, Miami of Ohio, and Tulane. This kid is my surprise player of the year, not only in the Big East, but in the whole NCAA. He was All-American second team by AP, and he was the only player in the last 10 years in the Big East to also win, not only win the player of the year, but also the freshman year in the Big East.
Pitt hoping to win their 10th game for the first time since 1981. Bank of America Stadium will be filled with Carolina blue coming up at 4:30 on ESPN.
Yeah, so that game coming up at the conclusion of the game in Detroit that we're watching now, Ohio and Marshall. So you see Pitt and North Carolina in Charlotte. What makes the difference in this one, Trevor?
Quarterback. Mm-hmm. Both quarterbacks are solid. The difference, Pitt's Bill Stahl is well protected by his offensive line. North Carolina's T.J. Yates, not so much. Yates spends too much time fleeing from angry hostiles. And so it's not fair, but it's football. So I see North Carolina's defense trying to really get after Stahl to make it a little more even though it's not very fair.
Well, Pitt-UNC is the next game, and then there's a third game at 8 Eastern out in San Francisco on ESPN, and that would be USC and Boston College. Not the bowl game that Southern California thought it would be in at the beginning of the season, but here they are, and we still don't know the status of tailback Joe McKnight, but head coach Pete Carroll caught up with Joe Tessitore this afternoon.
Coach, after being with the team this week and watching your practice, I am not going to question motivation or enthusiasm. Stuff was very spirited this week, but I do want to know, with the Joe McKnight situation, what effect has that had on you and the team?
Well, just disappointment for having to go through it for Joe, you know, and we're all right. We're working hard. You know, it's like a guy got banged up and he can't play, and that's how we have to deal with it. But it's just been disappointing for us to watch Joe have to go through that,
right?
Because it's something that isn't going to get resolved until later. So it's disappointing, but that's not a factor.
Your freshman quarterback had an interesting comment to me. He said, hey, I'll admit the grind of the season got to me, but the past few weeks, he says, mentally, physically, I feel like I'm fresh. What do you expect out of him?
Well, I'm hoping he'll play a real sharp football game. The extra attention to a game plan when you have 3 weeks to get through it is going to help him. Just getting a break away from the season and then starting over again, as happened through the finals period, I think helps him also. You know, and anytime a first-year guy gets a break and comes back, everything looks a little bit different. I don't know if this was enough of a break, but we're expecting Matt to play real sharp, good football. He's had great reps, and we're counting on him to give us a chance to win a football game.
For the casual sports fan out there that's used to seeing USC and BCS games and are just waking up to what happened this season, what's the quick explanation you give to that guy?
Well, we didn't handle the transitions of the losses from last year as well as we have in other years. That's simply that. You know, big quarterback transition, huge transition on defense that we thought maybe we could manage our way through it, and we needed to help a young quarterback, and we didn't play good enough defense because of it. And so we just have to go to work and get back at it and climb our way back, you know, to a position that we're really proud of.
All right, thanks, Coach.
All right, Joe.
All right, so Pete Carroll addressing, too, the 4 losses and why the drop down in production for USC, a lot of it defensively, but also offensively with that freshman quarterback. How much of this actually lies on Pete Carroll if he's feeling any heat at all?
You know, I think very little. It gets blown out of proportion because they're just down the freeway from Hollywood, for goodness sake. But when you look at that offense with a true freshman quarterback and a new offensive coordinator, you've got chemistry issues. That's not a head coaching issue. Same on defense with so much turnover in personnel and a new defensive coordinator. And so it's a matter of all the pieces gelling. And this year they didn't quite do that. It's not an easy thing to do, but 1 year of that doesn't mean the head coach failed.
So again, USC and Boston College, that's the Emerald Bowl, 8 o'clock Eastern time. Right here on ESPN. Meanwhile, it has been all Marshall so far. Two rushing touchdowns for the Thundering Herd as they lead Marshall 21-7. Trevor and I coming right back.
Some say David Abernathy's extraordinary confidence began at birth, when he congratulated the doctor on a perfect delivery. He later approached the much older Kerry Picor and simply said, "Call me." And she did. At 24, he performed open-heart surgery in a crowded opera house with a ballpoint pen. But when it comes to car buying, he's as nervous as anyone. So at 28, David Abernathy used Cars.com to regain his confidence to get the perfect car at the perfect price.
It was a horrible feeling, like I couldn't catch my breath. I couldn't believe I was actually having a heart attack. I remember being at the hospital, thinking about my wife. I should have done more to take care of myself. Now I'm exercising, watching my diet, and I trust my heart to Lipitor.
Unlike some other cholesterol-lowering medications, Lipitor is FDA-approved to reduce the risk of heart attack, stroke, and certain kinds of heart surgeries in patients with several common risk factors or heart disease. Lipitor is backed by over 17 years of research. Lipitor is not for everyone, including people with liver problems and women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. You need simple blood tests to check for liver problems. Tell your doctor if you are taking other medications or if you have any muscle pain or weakness. This may be a sign of a rare but serious side effect.
I'll never forget what I went through. Don't take your health for granted.
Have a heart-to-heart with your doctor about your risk and about Lipitor.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Bowl games to get you excited about. How about tomorrow's Gaylord Hotels Music City Bowl? C.J. Spiller and Clemson going up against Kentucky. They have an offensive weapon themselves.
So. That's right. Watch for the Wildcats. Randall Cobb, number 18. Former quarterback who now is a receiver, averaging over 11 yards per catch. He's a running back, averaging over 6 yards per carry. Runs the Wild Cobb formation. Keep an eye on him. He's an exciting player.
How about the Advocare 100 Independence Bowl? Texas A&M bowling again, taking on the Bulldogs of Georgia. That would be Sunday, 5 Eastern on ESPN2.
Aggies quarterback Jaraj Johnson lit up Texas in the final game of the regular season. This is a guy who is amazingly accurate with his arm, and so he throws receivers open. But he's also able to run. He's not particularly fast, but he's got the strength to be able to break tackles, gain yards, and extend drive. Now you see some of the tight passes he throws.
Yeah, he's going to make Big 12 defenses sweat still for a little bit more time. Straight ahead again the second half, Marshall and Ohio. Two offensive touchdowns, and as Trevor says, two non-offensive touchdowns in this game.
His reputation is expanding faster than the universe. He once had an awkward moment just to see how it feels. He lives vicariously through himself. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Stay thirsty, my friends.
Check it. Oh, no. a better battery? Get an Interstate battery. Outrageously dependable.
Should have had an Interstate.
I am one of 175 college students nationwide to earn an internship with Nike.
I am the nation's college photographer of the year, and that earned me an internship with National Geographic.
I am an engineer designing advanced antennas for GPS signals of the future.
I'm a business major, and my student investment management group grew $1 million to $1.5 million in just 2 years.
I am the promise.
I am the promise.
I am the promise of Ohio University.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Four friends.
Where are you guys?
We lost Doug.
Three friends.
And we're the three best friends that anybody could have.
And one night they'll never forget.
What is this?
That is my tooth. Why do you have that?
From the director of Old School.
Trust me, kids. You do not want to be sitting on these benches.
The Hangover. Movies playing on channels 125 through 199. This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any four movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
To a night we'll never forget.
Oh, my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any four movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
Welcome back to the Cars.com Halftime Report.
Oh, there you see it. It's what all the conferences crave. The Bowl Challenge Cup, and it goes to the conference for the best overall performance this bowl season. And so far, it belongs to Trevor Maddich's Mountain West Conference, home of his BYU Cougars. They're 3-0, Trevor.
What do you expect, really?
That kind of greatness.
Boring monotony, this greatness from the Mountain West.
BYU, Utah, and Wyoming all winning their bowl games so far. And some news from the NBA. Lakers forward Ron Artest will not play with the team tonight at Sacramento. Fell downstairs at his home last night, went to the ER, got stitches to the back of his head and his elbow. There is no timetable yet on Artest's return to the Laker lineup. Second half in Detroit coming right up.
This halftime report is presented by Cars.com, where confidence comes standard.
Some say David Abernathy's extraordinary confidence began at birth, when he congratulated the doctor on a perfect delivery. He later approached the much older Carrie Pecor and simply said, "Call me." And she did. At 24, he performed open-heart surgery in a crowded opera house with a ballpoint pen. But when it comes to car buying, he's as nervous as anyone. So at 28, David Abernathy used Cars.com to regain his confidence to get the perfect car at the perfect price.
An ordinary man in a race against time.
Just kept a hard right north on Alvarado.
He has the information.
He's always one step ahead of us. How's that possible?
Where's he going?
He has the tools.
Where's he heading?
But most of all, he has AT&T, the nation's fastest 3G network. Get 50% off all BlackBerry smartphones after mail-in rebate. Only from AT&T.
Lady, get out!
Hey, lady. This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
I tried the other energy drinks, and what made me switch was the size of the drinks kept getting bigger and bigger. I just wanted energy. I didn't want to get bloated. The 2 ounces of 5-Hour Energy really does make a difference. With the other energy drinks, it was kind of a sugar high. I felt on edge, and that's not what I'm looking for before I go on a mountain bike ride or a run or a swim, and I never felt that with 5-Hour Energy. It gave me a boost, and the boost lasted, and I never crashed. It gives you that sense of alertness. Nothing works like 5-Hour Energy.
Marshall University has done so very much for me. There's more than Matthew McConaughey. And if you ask me what I'll say.
Listen, coming from 6 hours away, Marshall University has become a home away from home for me.
It's an incredible place to learn, and take it from me, there's never a dull moment.
This is ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
Welcome back to the 2009 Little Caesars Bowl. We join you in downtown Detroit at Ford Field, where Marshall is leading Ohio 21-7 at the half. Ohio still looking for its first ever bowl victory, and we welcome you back to Detroit. Happy holidays to everyone. Pam Ward along with Ray Bentley. Boy, it was a weird first half, Ray. It easily could be very lopsided in favor of Marshall.
Yeah, they've had many opportunities, but Ohio hangs in there. That's what they've done all year. This is a team that has come back and won three games in the fourth quarter where they trailed. So stick around. Anything can happen. But here's what happened in the first half. Started out the first touchdown of the game. Martin Ward breaks four tackles, finds his way into the end zone, and then they come back with a punt return. Andre Booker fields this one. You're going to see unbelievable speed as he busts it outside, gets to the edge, and goes 58 yards to the house. 14-0 Marshall as they score two touchdowns in under 2 minutes. But Ohio hanging in there. They get the forced fumble by Jeff King. It's picked up by Shannon Ballard, and Shannon Ballard goes the distance for the ninth touchdown return of the season for the Bobcats. And it is a 14-point margin here as Marshall will receive the second half. As you see the numbers, and the thing that just blows me away, Pam, is Ohio with just 34 total yards in the first half.
They did not convert a third down. Time of possession squarely in favor of Marshall as well. They've had the ball 9 minutes longer than Ohio, but Ohio with its 11th, or make that its ninth non-offensive touchdown of the season, hanging around in there. Two trips for Marshall inside the 30. They came up with 0 points in the second quarter, and that is why it is only a 14-point ball game. Darius Marshall, the star running back for Marshall, gets the kick and is taken down at the 18-yard line. That was a 12-yard return. Jelani Woosley, a true freshman from Staten Island, made the tackle. So this is a thundering herd. Both teams started with three and outs, and then Marshall really got it going. And boy, the fumble and then the turnover on downs. It was a fourth and inches play. They pitched it back and lost.
I questioned that decision when it was made, and I'm sure they're second guessing themselves now as Noah Keller, the linebacker for the Bobcats, who had 11 tackles in that first half, made the stop on the fourth and short to get the ball back and thwart the scoring drive.
So Marshall starts the first half with the football. Ohio playing in the all green today. Boy, Martin Ward just stacked up right at the line of scrimmage by Lee Renfro. Might have picked up a half yard or so.
And the guy who made that play was Thad Turner, the corner. You don't see a corner spilling a counter OT or OF play very often, but Turner turned the shoulders and he spilled the thing, and Tafua comes in and makes the play.
They have some talent in that defensive backfield. Turner, who you mentioned, a returning starter, second team All-Mac, playing his final collegiate game. Second and nine for the Thundering Herd. Anderson with time to zip it out, but it's a little bit too low for Antavius Wilson. Got him right around the shoe tops.
Yeah, and the mechanics of Ryan Anderson were not very good on this. Watch his feet, and you see how his left foot is outside. When you step, you want to step right on a straight line towards where you throw. He opened it up a little bit, and that led the ball to go straight down into the ground. Some poor mechanics to start out by Brian Anderson. I think he's a lot better off when he throws the ball when he's getting hit. He just seems to have a knack for that.
He's been more accurate. In fact, he had completed 8 straight passes before that incompletion. Third and nine. They're 6 for 8 on third down conversion so far. Anderson swings it out to Ward, and Ward, who has a couple of touchdown runs as well as a 44-yarder, only picked up a yard. Julian Posey making the stop. Ohio forces a punt.
There's a good series to start the second half for Frank Solich and his Ohio Bobcats. They looks like they got a little talking to at halftime. I know Coach Stolich, he can tell you how it is, and he'll tell you in a hurry, and I'm sure he got after his football team. He told them they're very fortunate to only be down 14 in this game, but yet here they stand. They have a chance, and that defense came out, made a stop.
Case Whitehead with his second punt. Levon Brazil, very dangerous returner, is taken out as soon as he caught the football by Patrick Tafua.
And Brazil is dangerous both ways. See the struggles of the offense for Ohio. Six possessions, just two. That's right, two first downs. That's just not been a good start and a good half for this Ohio football team. You have to wonder what Tim Albin, their offensive coordinator, has come up with at halftime to try and get this thing going.
Check that, Ashton Hall made the nice stop as Brazil grabbed the punt. Ohio's offense has been stagnant today. Theo Scott trying to get it going, and he does. On the very first play, hits Taylor Price. There's the star receiver who in the first half only had one catch for 11 yards. That one good for 21.
Yeah, and he's going to be matched up on Omar Brown as the safety who's underneath who trails it. And then Daquan Bembry was the corner, and you saw the speed that Taylor Price has. I mean, he just ran past the coverage. There was no way Bembry could stay with him. And they picked up a blitz. It was a five-man rush, and they gave Theo Scott the time to throw the football.
21 yards, the longest offensive play for Ohio. Gives them a first down at the 34. Scott being pursued by McClellan. Wisely throws it well out of bounds.
Go ahead. Sorry, Pam. I was going to say Scott was not ready for that snap.
Mm-hmm.
That one hit him right in the gut. It's like, what's going on here? David White, the center. He snaps it, and, you know, Marshall didn't even believe it. You see, they didn't even really go, because I think it was a snap on a silent count. I'm not sure what David White is hearing down there, but nobody was ready for that snap.
Ohio fortunate to hang on to it. Brings up a second and 10. Scott with the fake hanging on to it, and a great tackle on the edge by Brandon Burns. Burns did not buy the fake by Scott and dropped him for a one-yard loss.
Yeah, a poor effort of blocking by Stephen Goulet. As you see on the outside on the top of your screen, right there, Goulet, number 87, he tried to throw a block on the defender, and you could see that Brandon Burns had no part. He said, you're not going to block me, and it was kind of half effort there, and Burns won that deal and stopped it for nothing. And receivers need to block good for that option to work. Didn't happen.
Ohio 0 for 6 on third downs in this game, and this is a third and 11. Scott completes it, but short of the first down. Price is marked 1 yard short of the first down marker.
He actually had the first down and then came back. Watch him. You see him, he catches the ball. He's across that yellow line. He tries to make a move and come back and then takes the first down away. That's a mistake by a receiver as far as not knowing where he is. If you've got the first down and then you're going to get hit, take the hit, go down right there and get the first down. And Price just reacted to it and cost his team. Now they're going to go on fourth and one.
Instead of going for about a 42-yard field goal, Scott and the offense stay out there. Their field goal kicker does have the range to make it. And they get it, or at least they're close to it. The mark, all important. Kellen Harris making the stop on Chris Garrett. Initially it looked like he got it from up here, but they're spotting it just a little bit short right now.
Yeah, that's going to be a measure situation because it is very close. And Kellen Harris, when he hit Garrett, he stopped him in his tracks. Watch this. Bam, right there. He is not past that line to make. And then you see the football is hanging back here, though. So I think the spot was good. We'll see what the measurement looks like, but I think they're going to be short. They didn't get it.
by about an inch.
It's a game of inches, and there's an inch that goes Marshall's way. Excellent defense. Kellen Harris coming up with a big stop along with Mario Harvey.
What do you think about the decision not to go for the 42-yard field goal? We'll talk about that when we come back, and we will also be joined by the new head coach of Marshall, John Doc Holliday. There he is, the new leader of the Thundering Herd, when we come back.
You want to score a deal on dinner? Then listen up, because this play is money. Everybody, cut right to your computer and type in LittleCaesars.com. Print the coupon there, and you get a large, freshly made, hot and ready pizza for an incredible $3.99. $3.99? This place is going wild, but it's good for 2 days only, so the clock is running. Get to Little Caesars with your coupon and seal the deal tonight.
Pizza, pizza.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Does Elmer Fudd have trouble with the letter R?
Shh, be very quiet. I'm hunting wabbits.
Okay, cut. I'm hunting rabbits, Elmer. Let's try that again.
Shh, I'm hunting wabbits.
Cut. Rabbits.
Wabbits.
Rabbits.
Wabbits.
Rabbits with an R.
Oh, this director's starting to rub me the wrong way.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
When the flu hits you hard, hit right back with Theraflu. Nothing fights your worst flu symptoms with more power. Theraflu. Good to be back.
Here we go!
Tony Hawk Ride. Available now for the lowest price of the season at Toys R Us. Board controller and game included. Tony Hawk Ride. Rated E10 for ages 10 and up.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes. And just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Welcome back to Detroit. Marshall leading Ohio 21-7 here in the third quarter of the Little Caesars Bowl. Rick Minter is the interim head coach, and we were pleased to be joined now by the new head coach of Marshall, John Doc Holliday, who's from Hurricane, West Virginia. Don't say hurricane, and yeah. And it's a pleasure to have you here.
Thanks, Pam. Really appreciate it, and thanks for having me.
All right, Doc Holliday, the West Virginia native, was on the staff of West Virginia University, and we're going to ask him a couple of questions after we get to see his team snap the ball. That's Brian Anderson, the quarterback. A little play action. And Anderson is taken down, sacked back at the 21-yard line. So again, joined here by Doc Holliday, the new head coach at Marshall. And the first question is, Coach, why did you decide to take this head coaching job?
Well, you know, I've always wanted to be a Division I head coach, Pam, and Marshall provided that opportunity, which is 20 minutes from my home. You know, I'm in West Virginia. I just love being there. And Marshall's a great school with a great tradition. Yeah, they were the winningest team in college football in the 90s. They had 114 wins under Jim Donnan and Bob Pruitt. I'm just really excited to get back there and get to work.
Was it difficult for you? I know that some of the message boards have been blowing up because you were a West Virginia staff guy. How's that working out, going to the dark side, according to Mountaineer fans?
I don't worry about that. You know, Pam, I'm just excited to be there. I'm a West Virginian, and just excited to have an opportunity to coach at Marshall.
Doc, you've been here a little bit. What's your initial impression of what you're inheriting here as far as the Marshall program and what you have?
Well, I think number one, Rick Minter and his staff done such a tremendous job preparing his football team under difficult situations. I think the thing that you really like to see as a football coach is how hard that team plays, and they're well prepared and they're playing hard today.
And as far as the things, I know you met with the football team. What was your message to them when you first got to meet them?
Well, my message was do it for the seniors. I mean, these guys have been through 5 years together, and it's important to put these seniors out in the winning note, and also for Marshall. I mean, we're going to start hitting the road recruiting on next week, and any exposure in the win can really help us in that area.
Here's a third and 12 for Anderson. He's under all sorts of pressure and goes down. So a very good defensive sequence there for Ohio as they will get the ball back. Now, you mentioned recruiting coach, and that really has been your bread and butter. You're known especially for going into Florida and getting quality athletes.
Well, you know, the one thing, you know, Urban Meyer has been a great mentor to me, and the one thing I learned about Urban is this is a player, just a personnel-driven game. You know, when Marshall had Randy Moss and Chad Pennington and Mike Barber and just all those great, great players, and Mod Bradshaw, they won a bunch of daggone football games. So there's some players out on that field, but we got to work like crazy to get some more.
All right, that is Doc Holliday, the new head coach of Marshall. Thanks so much for stopping by. We wish you all the success.
Thanks for having me. Thanks, Ray.
Thanks, Doc.
Thanks,
Tom.
And coach, as coach leaves the booth, it's probably a good thing he didn't see what transpired in the last few plays for Marshall. Rick Minter, the interim head coach. Ohio's going to get the ball in a good field position. We'll recap the last series when we return to Detroit.
All right, so you're driving down the freeway doing about 60 when you notice the guy next to you is steering with his knees, eating a cheeseburger, and talking on the phone. And that is exactly why the Ford F-150 is the safest truck in America. It's got a high-strength steel safety cage, side-impact airbags, safety canopy, 5-star crash rating, and roll stability control. Because it's not just crazy out there, it's certifiably insane, okay? It's not just a pickup truck. It's a Ford F-150.
You get a lot of different stuff from her, and it's all right here. Everything sent to you, organized by the person who sent it, the droid heiress. The droid that's as connected as you, exclusively at Verizon Wireless.
Critics and audiences agree, Invictus is great entertainment. And now it's been nominated for 3 Golden Globe Awards. Best Actor, Morgan Freeman. Best Supporting Actor, Matt Damon. And Best Director, Clint Eastwood.
This is our destiny!
Invictus, rated PG-13.
Excuse me. When you get a minute, can... When you get a minute...
Not too heavy, not too light. Bud Light. The difference is drinking.
In the NBA, you're always looking for an edge. You need to know your opponent better than they know themselves. Kobe, Carmelo, LeBron. I get my edge with NBA League Pass from DirecTV. I see every game, so I'm always ready. Are you?
Watch any NBA game you want, no matter where you live. Call today.
ESPN College Football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by Little Caesars Pizza, home of the large hot and ready pizza, always fresh, always ready. The Ford F-150, it's not just a pickup truck, it's a Ford F-150. And HTC, foams that get you.
And that is a look at, there's Mike Moody, one of our camera operators, and Mike Moody's with his family right here in the Detroit area. Very gracious. They rented out a hall. They had all of our crew over to celebrate Christmas together, and it was quite a do. Some great music from the band, too.
Yeah, right. Fun to listen to.
Flags are down on this play. Got a face mask coming up.
Janik made the play, but he made it on the face mask of Garrett. So that's one of those, it's good, but it's bad deals.
It was a 15-yard punt by Case Whitehead. It was just a shank. It was not blocked as we were going to break. And that set Ohio up in good field position at the 37.
Personal foul, face mask. Number 90, defense, 15-yard penalty.
And we get some more good field position. Here it is. You see the cutback right there. And, man, it just happens sometimes. You reach your arms out, especially with Garrett, who they list him at 5'8", but I think he's more about 5'6". And so when you think you're wrapping around a body, you end up around his head, especially when he's bent at the knees trying to make a cut. So a tough break for Michael Janik, making a big play, but it turns into a bad play.
Garrett has been playing on a bum ankle for much of the year, second all-time and all-purpose yards in Ohio history behind Calvin McCray. He's a terrific player for the Bobcats. All kinds of time for Theo Scott, but he can't hook up with his receiver, Brazil. And again, Ray, coming into this game, there was all this talk about the Ohio receivers, but we have yet to see that happen.
Yeah, and you're going to see it's just a double move out there by Brazil. He's going to fake inside and then run outside. A little post corner route, just no timing there, and then underthrown by Theo Scott. And I think Theo Scott is better out of the pocket than he is in the pocket as well, similar to, you know, Brian Anderson on the other side. Get him moving out to make that throw and you might have something.
Brazil, who has 51 catches on the season, just 1 for 4 yards today. Here's a 2nd and 10. Garrett with running room will be 1st and goal for the Bobcats. There we saw the speed of Garrett picking up 14.
All right, and this is just Janik, number 90. He has dived. He runs upfield too far. And Garrett is so quick getting to the line of scrimmage. You see number 90 right there. He's just too far away from it. Garrett is so fast and accelerating. He hit that hole. He ran right past him. Excellent play by Chris Garrett. Just kind of creasing and gashing that hurt defensive line.
The red zone has not been friendly to Ohio this year. 4th last as far as scoring touchdowns in the entire nation once they hit the red zone. But here's a 1st and goal. Scott going backwards, throws it towards Brazil in the back of the end zone. But it's incomplete. 17 touchdowns in 42 red zone trips coming into this game. That's only a 41% success rate. 116th in all of the bowl subdivision as far as scoring touchdowns, and that percentage now is down to 39.5%.
And the biggest problem they have is running the football when they get down here. I mentioned it early in the game. There are 4 running backs they use. All of them are 188 pounds, right around there, give or take 1 or 2. They don't have a battering ram or a big guy that can hammer it in, and they don't have a fullback. Their fullback got hurt prior to the season, so there's really nobody to lead the way up in here. A lot of times they just go to the Terrence McCray and just try to throw a jump ball to him.
First charge timeout, 2nd half. This is a 30-second timeout.
Ohio takes the timeout. They'll try to figure it out. Theo Scott, in fact, the quarterback, leads them with a whopping 3 rushing touchdowns. They only have 9 as a team. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tonight from San Francisco. It's the Emerald Bowl. Montel Harris and Boston College take on Pete Carroll's USC Trojans. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN and ESPN360.com tonight at 8 Eastern time.
There's going to be a couple of true freshmen in this game that are worth the price of admission. As you see, Keekly and Barkley. And then Luke Keekly is one of the best defensive players I have seen all season. He is just a ball magnet, just makes amazing plays, gets to the ball, and then everyone has seen Matt Barkley and the success that he has had as a true freshman when he's healthy for the USC Trojans.
Boy, Keekly, great story. He was with Hursley dealing with the cancer for Boston College. He's a guy, Keekly, who might have redshirted, right, instead as a star as a true freshman. After the timeout, what will Ohio do? 2nd and goal at the 7. Oh, Garrett, nothing doing. Chris Garrett met 4 Marshall players. James Burks, the first there, to drop him for a 2-yard loss.
And Burks just works a little stunt. You watch him, he's going to work this way and then come back and split the blocks right there, and it's almost a misstep as number 76, Cadre Pinder, he stepped outside expecting Burks to go that way. Burks didn't do it. He came back, and there was nobody there left to block it.
Here's a 3rd and goal, now from the 9. Scott dropped the snap, recovered, throws it into the end zone, and it is caught for the touchdown. What a catch by Terrence McCray. Had to go up high and got his foot in for the score.
That's what I said earlier in this drive, Pam. A lot of times what they like to do is just throw a jump ball to Terrence McCray, who's a former basketball player at 6'4". He's able to jump up over Daquan Bembry, who's only 5'10", and take the football out of the air like he used to grab rebounds. I mean, he's done this several times. Did it against Ball State earlier in the year. And, you know, he had a basketball offer at Duquesne College, and he almost took it, and that was a basketball rebound right there.
Terrific play by McCray. Weller adds the extra point. Ohio gets into the red zone and scores a touchdown. We only have a 7-point ball game in the Little Caesars Bowl.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
All right, the commercial's on, so you're probably halfway to the fridge. So I'm going to talk loud. Save your appetite for dinner, which I'm about to save you money on. Get to your computer and type in littlecaesars.com. You know what you'll see there? A coupon that gets you a large, hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. You heard me right, $3.99. Today and tomorrow only, and only with coupon. A large, hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. The best value in America just got better. How's that for appetite appeal?
Pizza, pizza.
To pursue the life you want, you need a financial advocate who knows where you want to go. A Merrill Lynch financial advisor, now with access to the resources of Bank of America, can help you diversify, rebalance, imagine, and believe. Merrill Lynch Wealth Management.
Like most of us on the force, I work with a partner. This is mine, Blitz. I can't do this job without him, and he can't do it without me. To keep him at his best, I only feed him Yukonuba with prebiotics to promote strong defenses. You know, he means the world to me for a lot of different reasons. He's more than a partner. He's family.
Ask an expert at your pet store which formula is best for your dog.
A Monday night battle from the black and blue division, Coach.
It's time to pound a rock.
Intense NFC North rivals meet for a Monday night slugfest.
Brett Favre and the Vikings are fighting for prime playoff position.
But Jay Cutler and the Bears will be on the prowl for an upset.
Can the division champs get back on track, or will Chicago bear down for a Windy City win?
ESPN Monday Night Football, Vikings Bears at 8:30.
Terrence McCray has just caught his 9th touchdown catch of the season. That is number one on this Ohio team. And there he is explaining to his teammates how he was able to go up and get that jump ball. And Ohio all of a sudden has scored 14 straight points. Very much in this game. Andre Booker has a punt return for a touchdown today. And he loses the kick return. Ball on the turf. But the officials are saying he was down. Ohio that close to getting the turnover. Mario Harvey was able to... So jump on it.
Rick Minner is like, oh boy. Watch this. Here's the ball coming out. Is it out before he's down? The elbow is down on the ground right here. That means he's down, but you can't see the football. It's behind the leg right there. That's a tough one to call from that angle.
And that is the other 30, Eric Benjamin for Ohio, who pounced on it.
Can't see the ball in that angle. Remember, it has to be indisputable video evidence, and we have it right there. He's down before that ball came out, in my opinion, and they're not going to stop it. They must agree.
Chad Clemons forced the fumble. Marshall hangs onto it, and that's a big-time hit by Julian Posey on Antavius Wilson, who couldn't come up with the football.
Posey is a guy that they told us, John Shannon told us, the offensive coordinator, they were going after him. Listen to this one. Nice big hit there from Julian Posey, who is starting because Idris Lawrence was hurt during the MAC championship game against Central Michigan. He got cut. That put Posey in the starting lineup, but Posey's played a lot. He had a late interception against Northern Illinois, which proved to be a game winner.
Took that one 41 yards for a touchdown. Anderson flushed out yet again. throws that one, and Posey was the closest player to it. And this Ohio Bobcat team really rejuvenated. Good pressure from Notstein.
This is a different Bobcat defense here in the second half. They're getting pressure on the quarterback. They had their first two hits or two sacks on him. And look at the difference by half, Ohio compared to Marshall. And that's, I'll tell you, there's two things going on here. Number one, the Bobcat defense is playing very good football, inspired football. And then the offense has found some things in the passing game.
Here's a third and 10. And they throw it short to Darius Marshall, and that play had no chance of success. Shannon Ballard that time. Ballard, who has a 75-yard fumble return for a touchdown, made the stop, and you can see the frustration on Brian Anderson's face.
Yeah, Stafford Gatling is the guy I want you to watch. Defensive lineman, watch how they peel back and come running back after this thing. Right there, it's thrown. Here they come, a hustling. Gatling is way back by the quarterback, and he comes in and makes the hit after Ballard forces it back inside. Just great hustle by the front four for the Bobcat defense.
Whitehead into punt. Last time he did it, he shanked one for 15 yards. And that one's blocked. Ohio gets the ball in terrific field position. Chad Clemens, there you see him, number 44, coming in to block the punt.
Marshall runs that shield punt protection. They just put three guys in front of the punter. Here they are, one, two, three, and Gatling is just going to come right up the middle. And watch him just shoot right up in there. Excuse me, Clemens is coming right up the middle, shoots in there, and nobody in that shield picks him up. Puts a move to the inside on the linebacker, Kellen Harris, and that's a huge play by Clemens. A lot of times games will hinge and turn on a big special teams play, and Ohio has that opportunity right now.
And it's a fifth block kick for Ohio this season, second for Clemens. A completion to Brazil, and he is able to take it 5 yards down to the 30. So, boy, has this been quite a third quarter for the Bobcats. Trailed this game at one point, 21-0. Fumble return for a touchdown. They scored a touchdown the last time they had a short field because of a short punt by Whitehead of 15 yards, and then Whitehead had that one blocked right at the line of scrimmage. Handoff, short gain for Vince Davidson. Picked up about a yard. Mario Harvey coming up with the stop for Marshall. And the Ohio offense really turning it around here in the third quarter.
Yeah, and that's, I think they found some things in the throwing game. We've seen a couple of passes down the field. The touchdown to McCray. Price has been open a couple of times. And that in turn has opened up Garrett running between the tackles a little bit. So a nice mix with this offense. And like they've done all year, the pass has set up the run for Ohio.
They are, however, 0-for-8 on third downs today. Here's a third and four, and that one should have been or could have been intercepted by Mario Harvey looking for Brazil, but Harvey had that well covered. Ohio on the game, 0-for-9 on third downs.
Boy, Harvey just has a great feel. See him at the top of your screen. He just works and gets underneath Brazil. And Brazil's a fast, shifty receiver, and yet Harvey has the quick enough feet to get out there and get underneath that little whip route.
Matt Weller going to try a 46-yard field goal. He has hit two from 50 yards plus this season. And nails that one. Make it 17 straight points for the Bobcats. A 46-yard field goal for Matt Weller, already with the most field goals by any freshman in the nation. Now has 21 on the season. So the block punt resulting in 3 points for the Bobcats. Monday night, don't miss an NFC North battle in Soldier Field. Brett Favre and the Vikings roll into Chicago to take on Jay Cutler and the Bears. Monday night football at 8:30 Eastern. Coverage starts with Monday night countdown served by Applebee's at 7 Eastern. We were visited at halftime here in the booth by Rick Spielman, the terrific general manager for the Minnesota Vikings, who has put so many of those pieces into place. And he was saying, you know, the Favre thing, it's just going to blow over. Everything's going to be fine between he and Brad Childress. And things not going so well for the Vikings in their last three games offensively. See if they can turn it around against Chicago on Monday night.
Yeah, I think the biggest problem for the Vikings right now is their offensive line.
Or lack thereof.
Right, a little sinking spell up there.
We have got ourselves a ball game. It looked like it would be anything but, with Marshall up 21 to nothing. But Ohio with the kickoff to Andre Booker. And Booker is taken down with authority just short of the 25-yard line. Had an 18-yard return. Terrific coverage by Alphonso Lewis, a backup linebacker.
And you can see that this Ohio Bobcat football team is fired up. One of the true measures of your emotional state of your football team is how they cover kicks, and Lewis just showed them right there. They're flying high right now.
Marshall with 9 offensive plays in the second half, and you see it right there, -1 yard. Including a couple of sacks by Gatling and Williamson, respectively, when we were talking to Doc Holliday up here in the booth at the beginning of the third quarter.
Marshall's gotten away from the pounding running game, and now they're back at it, but Ohio's ready for it.
That time Darius Marshall got pounded by Notestein. We talked about Dak. What a great story he is. A preferred walk-on. Got scholarship offers from smaller schools, but his dad played a year at Ohio, so he decided to walk on. Got his scholarship before this, his junior season, and he has been a really solid player for them.
He really has, Bam, not only in putting pressure on the quarterback, but also against the run, as we just saw in that last play.
Right back to Marshall, who slips a tackle. Picks up about 4 yards. Noah Keller with his 10th tackle of the game.
And the Ohio Bobcat defense, as you see the Marshall offense and what they've gotten done here in the second half, the Bobcats have loaded up the box. They are basically challenging Marshall to throw the football. They're putting 8 and 9 even in the box against these double tight end sets, and they're outnumbering the Thundering Herd, and they're saying, I dare you to throw the football. And I think Marshall's going to have success doing that in order to break them and get them out of that big heavy run front.
They're 0 for 3 on their last third down attempts, but they pick one up, rushing across the field after the catch is Chuck Walker. Pick up 12 yards, and that's a big first down. Marshall certainly needed it to stem this Ohio Tide.
And a nice little play that they're going to run right here. You're going to see one receiver go up the field and then the other clear underneath. And that drives the defenders back. You see the tight end going up the field. That's Thompson. And then Walker runs underneath. It clears it out. And a nice throw by Anderson to get the thing going.
First down of the second half for Marshall. They have a first down on their own 42. Nothing at all for Terrell Edwards-May. Noah Keller again. The middle linebacker from Kearney, Nebraska, just stopped that hole.
Yeah, here's Noah Keller. They got him right in the middle, and they got him back about 6 yards so he can diagnose. And that's what he does the best. He knows where the play's going, and he'll meet you in the hole. Oh, good video or good audio there. Our guy Andy Bartley down in the truck getting it done on the audio, and we want to say hello and wish his father Robert Bartley the best as he is in the hospital recovering, and we wish the Bartley family the best in that deal.
Son Andy, one of the best guys you'd ever want to have on your crew. There's flags down as that pass is completed downfield to Antavius Wilson, but we anticipate a hold to bring it back.
That's too bad, because that was a really nice throw, probably the best throw of the day from Anderson.
Holding, number 68 offense, 10-yard penalty, second down.
Gravancha, who's been playing guard and working in there, he's the one who gets the hold. And you can see right there, you're having to hold the back of the jersey of Marcellus Williamson.
That negates a 26-yard gain to Wilson. Ball all the way back to the 32-yard line of Marshall.
That was a really nice throw. Got that over the underneath coverage, but dropped it down in front of the safety over the top.
So instead of first and 10 at the Ohio 32, it's second and 20. Anderson taken off and taken down. Maybe a half yard or so upfield by Lee Renfro, these very active linebackers. They have those two captains in there, Renfro and Keller.
They are. They fly around. They're fun to watch. And, you know, I mentioned previously, Pam, they're undersized a little bit. You know, they got the two big guys up front anchoring the thing. But Noah Keller's not undersized. He's the one legit in terms of, you know, fitting that prototype at 6'1", 231 pounds. He's the real deal, and I've seen him develop over the last couple of years. He's a guy that, if he continues, could play on Sunday.
Anderson takes a shot downfield, and he overthrows his intended receiver, the true freshman Aaron Dobson. Good coverage by Patrick Tafua.
That's a classic example of how Anderson moves up in the pocket to buy extra time and then make a throw. See him, watch him. He's going to hit the back foot. He feels that pocket. He's going to move up in it, and try to launch this thing down the middle. But it's just good coverage down the field, as Tafua is not going to let Dobson get even close to that one.
Tafua has three picks on the season. He and Gerald Moore doing a very good job at the safety spot. There's a Patrick, who is an accomplished Polynesian dancer, very proud of his Polynesian heritage, the California native. And that one was almost gotten too. And that was Utanamoan, the kicker that time, who punted. Brazil gets it. On the other side for Ohio.
I've seen LaVon Brazil do this on so many punts on film, where he just lets that thing roll around and then tries to get it. And he's dangerous. Here's the near block coming from the outside. That is very close by Stephen Goulet. And then on the end, watch this thing. It's bouncing around. Get away from it. There's a poison call. But LaVon Brazil likes to live dangerously. And he still comes up with it.
So two straight bad punts by Case Whitehead, a 15-yarder and one block. So they bring in the kicker, Retanamorn, to punt. It was a 39-yarder, nearly blocked. Scott completes it to Stephen Goulet, who almost got the block punt. Picked that one up, give him a first down and 13 yards. This is Little Caesars Bowl. We're coming to you from downtown Detroit in Ford Field. Andre Booker with a 58-yard punt return. Martin Ward has scored a couple for the Herd, but Ohio is thundered back from a 21-0 deficit. Shannon Ballard's fumble return got it going, and they have had the better of Marshall here in the third quarter. And only trail at 21-17. Scott has the pocket collapse on him, and he goes down. Mario Harvey coming in to sack him for a 14-yard loss.
And Mario Harvey is a relentless pass rusher. He's one of the best I've seen coming from back. He's got 5 sacks. That's his 6th now on the year. And, I mean, he'll beat offensive linemen. He'll come after you. And that time, I believe he ran over Eric Herman. And he tracks down Theo Scott. And Scott's slow to get up.
End of the third quarter. We'll check on the starting quarterback for Ohio. When we come back, got a close ball game here in the Little Caesars Bowl.
Away from your TV for Capital One Bowl Week, watch it live online at ESPN360.com.
Could switching to GEICO really save you 15% or more on car insurance? Is Ed too tall, Jones too tall?
I was gonna guess to me.
GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more.
We started with over 1 billion colors. Generously added more than 2 million liquid crystal pixels. Combined 960 backlighting LEDs with 240 flawless scenes per second, made it 50% more energy efficient. and it all came down to one thing. The new 55-inch True LED from Vizio. Superior picture performance, superior price from America's number one LCD HD TV company.
Verizon makes a big deal about their maps, but when you look a little closer, their story begins to fall apart. See, AT&T lets you talk on the phone while you surf the web. Verizon doesn't. AT&T has the most popular smartphones and the nation's fastest 3G network. Verizon doesn't. Glad that's cleared up.
Oh, AT&T, a better 3G experience. This holiday, get a touchscreen Samsung Solstice free after mail-in rebate.
It's the best week of the year, Capital One Bowl Week. Boston College battles USC. Tonight at 8 on ESPN. College football lives here.
You value your friends. So does DirecTV. Bob's worth 100. So are Carrie, Ann, and Sue. For every friend you refer to DirecTV, you get $100. And they get $100 on top of our new customer offer. Just give your account number to your friends and have them call 1-877-4-100-EACH. They must have your account number when they order. This offer's only good for a limited time, so hurry. Then celebrate and watch the Benjamins stack up.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any four movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
To a night we'll never forget.
Yeah. Oh my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any four movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
In one-third of its nine wins on the season, Ohio has had to mount fourth-quarter comebacks to get a victory. And they are setting up for another one. At one point down 21-0 to Marshall. It's now just 21-17. We begin the fourth quarter at the Little Caesars Bowl. Theo Scott shaken up on that last play. The quarterback still in there for the Bobcats on second and 25. Took a huge loss on that sack. Scott with a little shovel pass, completes it to Stephen Goulet, and Goulet is able to break free down the sideline. Boy, that's a big 20 yards on a second and 25.
And Theo Scott did a nice job of moving up in the pocket. Garrett's going to cut Harvey, and Theo Scott runs right by him, breaks the arm tackle, has the time to dump it down to Goulet, who shows you some good run after the catch ability.
Goulet, a junior out of Irmo, South Carolina. Theo Scott, senior from Long Beach, originally committed to Cal out of high school, redshirted there, never played, then went to a junior college for 1 year, now his third and final year with Ohio. Facing a third and four. Only a three-man rush by Marshall gave Scott all the time in the world to find his top receiver, Taylor Price, for the first down.
And Taylor Price got pressed out here. Actually, he's on the outside. Look at him work inside. I'll tell you, this is what Ohio continues to do in their passing game. They run an inside guy up the field to clear out, and then they bring the outside guy underneath that into that little wash area, right into the wake of it, and they drop it down, and it's been very successful for him here in this second half.
No receiver.
Please check the stands. We definitely hear something that sounds like a whistle coming from the stands. We can't have that. Please correct that.
And I heard it too, especially two plays ago, Robert Cameron talking about a whistle in the stands. And I clearly heard that. It sounds like it's coming from our side of the field, Ray.
This isn't a soccer match. Leave your whistles at home. It's very disruptive. Players are trained almost like Pavlov's dogs. And that whistle goes, you stop drooling.
Which did not necessarily, I think, apply to you.
No, I kept drooling the whole time.
Ohio, after going 0 for 10 in third downs as he converted on its last two. Scott in a boatload of trouble, escaped. He's still on his feet. Theo Scott somehow able to get away from John Jacobs. They only lost 4 yards, but it could have been a whole lot worse. There's a flag down.
Yeah, Garrett got hit late by Brandon Burns, and this is going to be 15 big yards against Marshall. Another defenseless player shot at the end of a play.
After the play, personal foul, number 8, defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Brandon Burns making the critical error of continuing play late, and they're not going to let you hit defenseless players. Point of emphasis this year, and I think rightly so. You know, you don't want to see somebody get hurt, which we did earlier. We saw Vinnie Curry get hurt. And here it is right in the front of your screen, and at the end of the play, Burns throws Garrett to the ground, and Garrett might have took a little bit of a dive.
Garrett doesn't weigh a whole lot. But that was a good flop. It worked.
Yeah, yes.
Looked like a Duke basketball player taking a charge.
Ouch. Here's a pass.
Brazil looking to throw. Got a man wide open. It's Price, and he missed him. Boy, Price had 6 points written all over him. But Brazil couldn't get it to him.
And the thing that made this not work was the jam. Look at the jam. Excuse me. Look at the jam right down here by the defender, the cornerback on Price. See him, how he holds him up, and then Price staggered his step, and he goes the distance over the top. He's open, but Shakur had the press on him that disrupted the timing just enough. And that's why Levon Brazil plays receiver, because he had him open.
Instead, it brings up a 2nd and 10. Whistles before the play.
Timeout, Ohio.
That was called from the sideline as Coach Solich didn't like what he had out there, and he took that timeout. The play clock was also winding down.
Ohio trying to complete this comeback, takes a timeout.
You want to score a deal on dinner? Then listen up, because this play is money. Everybody, cut right to your computer and type in LittleCaesars.com. Print the coupon there, and you get a large, freshly made, hot and ready pizza for an incredible $3.99. $3.99? This place is going wild, but it's good for 2 days only, so the clock is running. Get to Little Caesars with your coupon and seal the deal tonight.
Pizza, pizza.
The Chevy Malibu and Toyota Camry received 5-star crash safety ratings, but only Malibu has OnStar.
Big deal. I'll just use my phone.
Let's say we crashed. Whoops, your phone's gone. OnStar Automatic Crash Response can call to see if you're okay. If you don't answer, they can automatically send help.
I think I'll ride with you.
Now during the Chevy Red Tag event, get an 09 Malibu with 0% APR for 72 months. See red and save green now at your local Chevy dealer.
The right look should suffice. Stay thirsty, my friends.
They're running the men's room marathon.
With lots of guys going over and over.
And here's the dash to the men's room with lots of guys going urgently.
And then there's the night game.
Waking up to go.
These guys should be in a race to see their doctors.
Right, those could be urinary symptoms due to BPH, an enlarged prostate.
But for many guys, prescription Flomax reduces their urinary symptoms due to BPH in 1 week.
Only your doctor can tell if you have BPH, not a more serious condition like prostate cancer.
When taking Flomax, avoid driving or hazardous tasks until you know how Flomax will affect you, as a sudden drop in blood pressure may occur, rarely resulting in fainting.
Tell your doctor about all medications you take. If considering cataract surgery, tell your eye surgeon you've taken Flomax.
Common side effects are runny nose, dizziness, and decrease in semen.
Ask your doctor if Flomax is right for you.
Call 877-4-FLOMAX to see if you qualify for up to $40 off new or refill prescriptions.
For many men, Flomax can make a difference in 1 week.
The
Dari Noka in studio with this bowl update brought to you by Flomax. Want to remind you there are two more bowl games today on ESPN. Coming up at 8 Eastern, you get USC at Boston College in the Emerald Bowl. But coming up next, the Meineke Car Care Bowl. Pitt and North Carolina. Pittsburgh, a win away from number 10 on the season. It would be the Panthers' first 10-win season since 1981 when one Dan Marino was quarterback. Pitt, North Carolina, coming up 4:30 Eastern from Charlotte. Pam?
Well, welcome back. Ohio taking the timeout as the play clock was winding down, ready to snap it. Trailing in the Little Caesars Bowl, 21-17. Sue Marshall. Brazil comes in motion, and Scott pitches it to him, and he is taken down inbounds by Omar Brown. We saw Brazil misfire on a pass. He had been 2 for 2 during the season on pass plays, including a touchdown, but he overshot Taylor Price a few plays ago that could have given Ohio its first lead. And Ohio's offense really, really struggling on third downs, but they've hit their last two, and here's another one coming up, 3rd and 9.
Yeah, their one touchdown was on a 3rd and long. They threw it up for grabs to Terrence McCray.
Scott stepping up, has to try to run for the first down. Instead, he went laterally, then put a cut on at the last minute, and there's a late hit. Marshall's going to give him another first down on a penalty. Ashton Hall smacks Scott at the sideline.
Boy, that's the second 15-yarder on a 3rd down that Marshall has committed, which has allowed this Ohio drive to stay alive.
After the play, personal foul, lays it out of bounds. Number 20 on the defense, 15-yard penalty, 1st down.
Theo Scott threw it in reverse and then kept going, and you can see that's a very late hit by Ashton Hall. You just got to stop, man. You can't do that. Here it is in real speed. Watch the gear shift right here. The old okey-doke from Theo Scott got him some extra yards, but then the hit late by Hall out of bounds got him some more extra yards.
This drive has already covered 60 yards, about 3.5 minutes, and a gift first down. They were about a yard or so short of the first down before the Hall hit, kept it going, and the ball was moved into and down to the 13-yard line. Scott flares it out to Garrett, bobbled it, held on to it, tackled down by John Jacobs.
And Jacobs is in a walk-away position and goes to the flat and then explodes on the ball. I don't think Garrett had that thing until Jacobs hit it right onto his chest.
It would have been better had he not caught it because he lost a yard.
Yeah, Jacobs very easily could have snagged that thing himself. It was right there in front of him.
Red zone very poor during the regular season. That's 116th out of 120 teams in the bowl subdivision, but they are 1 for 1 today. With the touchdown to McCray that Ray just mentioned. Garrett going down the right sideline, going to bring up a 3rd and long. Jacobs and Harvey converging on the tackle.
Boy, Harvey just takes on blockers. He's got such great body position. He's so explosive. I'm so impressed with this junior. 6 foot, 247 pounds, has a lot of power packed into the legs. And he is all over the field. You can't block him because he'll either run around you, but most of the times he's a run right through you guy. He gets off blocks as well as anybody I've seen all year long.
And one of the great nicknames too, nicknamed Thumper. Scott throws it up in the end zone for McCray, and that time it's not catchable. Daquan Bembry had the better play on the ball. Brings up a 4th down and another field goal try for Matt Weller, who has already hit from 46.
Yeah, they tried to go to that same old well to throw a jump ball to McCray and overthrown by Scott. And if you're going to throw a jump ball, I think you got to keep it in bounds and in the vicinity of McCray. Give him a chance because he will outjump anybody. But he wasn't given a chance by Theo Scott on that one.
29-yard attempt to get Ohio to within a point. and he missed it. A severe angle on the hash, and Matt Weller, who has more field goals than any freshman kicker in the nation, and also the most field goals in any single season for an Ohio player with 21, missed that 29-yarder, and it remains a four-point game. So a big drive by Ohio results in no points.
Well-informed people are considering Chevy Malibu.
You a cop?
No.
You didn't hear it from me, but this Malibu, it offers better highway mileage than a comparable Camry or Accord.
Estimated 33 highway. I saw that on the EPA site.
So how come the Malibu costs so little?
It's a Chevy.
You have cop hair.
Now during the Chevy Red Tag event, get an 09 Malibu with 0% APR for 72 months. See red and save green now at your local Chevy dealer.
This is no time to play. I'm picking a photo for my Capital One credit card. Old man Sutter? Why would I put his picture on my card? Nice drawing, but this photo's cuter.
Personalize your card by uploading your own photo at CapitalOne.com.
Lady, what's in your wallet?
911, what's your emergency?
It was at the comedy club. That's when I had it with heartburn. The guy was hilarious, but I was in pain, so I stepped out.
What are you, walking out on me? It's a passing curfew.
I will never make that mistake again. That's when I'd had it with frequent heartburn. And that's when I got Prevacid 24-hour. And my sense of humor back.
The number one prescribed acid reducer brand over the last decade is now over-the-counter to treat frequent heartburn a full 24 hours. Prevacid 24-hour. When you've had it with heartburn.
Tailgating isn't an event, it's an art. You gotta get here early if you wanna get a good spot. You gotta think about things like the sun, the wind direction. Things the rookies never think of, but we veterans know. You need at least two or three meat varieties, a couple different drinks, no vegetables. You know, if I'm gonna do something, I'm gonna do it right. Same with taking care of the truck that gets me here. That's why I use Napa parts. Mm-hmm. Is it too early for a brat? Mm-hmm.
ESPN College Football, the Little Caesars Bowl, is brought to you by Chevy and their award-winning cars, trucks, and crossovers. Capital One, what's in your wallet? And Prevacid 24-hour, when you've had it with heartburn.
Well, welcome back to the Little Caesars Bowl. We have a 21-17 ball game. Ohio has scored the last 17 points of this game. The Bobcats trying to win their first bowl ever in their fourth bowl appearance. And we have a new quarterback in there. Press Taylor in for Brian Anderson for Marshall.
Number 13,
and there he is. Press, a junior out of Norman, Oklahoma, a junior college transfer.
And more of a running type quarterback. And that's what they bring him in to run. It's almost like a wildcat situation when he's in there. Not much of a passing game, although he will throw it, but it gives you the dual threat of the quarterback running the ball as well as handing off.
Picked up 4 yards on that keeper. Holds on to it again and runs for the first down.
Yeah, I think this is a great call by Rick Mentor to make this move and get another style of offense. Ohio had obviously figured out how to stop what they were doing. So let's go to plan C or D or E, whatever one you got to go to down the line. And Press Taylor is that guy. And as I said, a true threat. This is nothing more than a wildcat offense with him in there.
Picked up 11 yards on that carry. Before this series, Marshall only had 19 yards of offense in the second half. Taylor giving him a boost, now pitches it to Darius Marshall, and Marshall finds some running room. Boy, that's a big tackle by Thad Turner, or else Marshall had a lot of field turf in front of him.
Yeah, Noah Keller, the inside linebacker, had a beat on this. You see him 47, but he runs into his own guy. So he effectively got blocked by his own man, or he was ready to meet the running back Marshall at the line, but instead it goes for a nice little 7-yard pickup.
Keeping it on the ground again, this time to Terrell Edwards-May. Sophomore from Mobile, tackled down by Noah Keller, who has about a dozen tackles today, following up his 16 tackle effort, a MAC title game record in the loss to Central Michigan in early December here.
Got some ink on those arms, and I'm sure he's got some bruises too. He gets in a lot of action.
Third and two for Marshall. Taylor still in there at quarterback. On the roll, then he cuts back and dives a couple of yards short of the first down. Didn't pick up anything.
No, and I think he made a mistake here in bailing out too soon, because he had a man open in the flat. Had he continued to work outside, he could have had an easy throw for the first down. But that's some inexperience from Press Taylor, and also maybe some over-reliance on his running ability.
And they're going to punt it on fourth and two, and again, it's the kicker, Bertanamorn, coming in. Case Whitehead had struggled as the punter. So here's the second punt for the Bertanamorn. His first one was for 39 yards. LaVon Brazil, who has three punt returns for touchdowns this year, waits back on the 22 for Ohio.
And got a warm-up one. It's a good thing for a kicker to do if that whistle blows and you've got it in your hands.
Offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Punt that thing anyway. Get yourself a warm-up.
And Bertanamorn was a very good soccer player. He was a goalie, and of course goalies, when they kick out of their own goal, it's kind of like a punt.
Yeah, nothing more, nothing less. It's dropping the ball and kicking it.
So he certainly has experience at that, and the Marshall folks were telling us that he was very much a novice at football. He said he wasn't sure that Craig could say where all the NFL teams even played before he started playing football for Marshall.
He's had a great year. He might have a chance to go to one of those places he's not aware of.
Right through the hands of Brazil. He's able to pick it up on the bounce. Flirting with danger yet again. That's a 42-yard punt. Aaron Dobson made the stop.
Well, that Brazil's a double-edged sword. He lets this one go through his hands, but he gets the fortuitous bounce. And Marshall hanging on by four.
Capital One Bowl Week continues through January 2nd.
All right, the commercial's on, so you're probably halfway to the fridge. So I'm going to talk loud. Save your appetite for dinner, which I'm about to save you money on. Get to your computer and type in LittleCaesars.com. You know what you'll see there? A coupon that gets a large hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. You heard me right, $3.99. Today and tomorrow only, and only with coupon. A large hot and ready pizza for just $3.99. The best value in America just got better. How's that for appetite appeal?
Pizza, pizza.
For a better looking tomorrow. Vicks NyQuil cold and flu. The nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, fever, best sleep you ever got with a cold medicine. For a better looking tomorrow. Now also available, Vicks NyQuil less drowsy, because everyone sleeps differently.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema. Four friends.
Where are you guys?
We lost Doug.
Three friends.
And we're the three best friends that anybody could have.
And one night they'll never forget.
What is this?
That is my tooth. Why do you have that?
From the director of Old School.
Trust me, kids, you do not want to be sitting on these benches.
The Hangover. Movies playing on channels 125 through 199.
This December, celebrate with our best offer of the year.
Wow.
Get over $10 cash back from DirecTV Cinema when you order any four movies between now and the end of the year.
I love it.
Movies like The Hangover.
Through a night we'll never forget.
Yeah. Oh, my God.
Julie and Julia.
I'm becoming a much better person because of her.
Bonjour.
Terminator Salvation.
We are all dead.
This month, order any four movies and get over $10 cash back. DirecTV Cinema, channels 125 through 199.
Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN Sunday night. Derek Locke and the Kentucky Wildcats take on the ever-exciting C.J. Spiller and Clemson in the Gaylord Hotel's Music City Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week on ESPN and ESPN360.com. Sunday at 8:30 Eastern Time. This is Little Caesars Bowl in downtown. downtown Detroit, Ohio, down by four with the football. They only have one timeout left, 7:05 left to go. Chris Garrett, their leading running back, picks up five on that carry. And when we are through here in Detroit, we will take you to Charlotte for the Meineke Car Care Bowl, where Pittsburgh will take on North Carolina. Our good friend Chris Spielman down there, part of the broadcasting crew.
And Chris is going to be excited about that North Carolina defense because they fly around. They've got some players on that defense.
I think a slobber knocker will be coming out of Chris's mouth. Robert Quinn among the great talent on that North Carolina defense. Oh, my. Theo Scott simply dropped the snap on second and five.
He just took his eye off the shotgun snap. Watch his head. See him, how he kind of took his eyes up to the field. And most times the quarterbacks have no problem handling those things. This one, the ball came a little weird in his hands. And when he tried to secure it, it just kind of flopped out of there.
So the Marshall fans screaming for their defense on a third and eight. Here comes the blitz from Harvey, and down goes Scott. Mario Harvey coming in there for his second sack of the game.
And he don't mess around when he gets home either. He is just great at keeping that great knee bend position and then finishing off. Bam, right there. That's a good. That, you talked about slobber knockers. We're going to give that one a slobber knocker right there.
What a great defensive stand there for Marshall. Theo Scott shaking up again on the sideline. Here's Hershey kicking out of his end zone. A lot of air underneath it. Booker stays away. That's a 43-yard punt for Hershey, again pressed into action today because starting punter Matt Schulte not here because of a violation of team policy. Your game story? Well, Marshall, talk about a thundering herd, thundered out of the gates with a 21-0 lead. Andre Booker with an exciting 58-yard punt return. Martin Ward with a couple of rushing touchdowns. But Ohio, who scored the last 17 points, including their ninth non-offensive touchdown of the year with a 75-yard fumble return for a score by Shannon Ballard. But Marshall has the football, and Brian Anderson, after taking the last series off, is back in, and he pitches it to Darius Marshall, who runs for the first down. Smart, too, because he stayed in bounds. Clock keeps going.
And he got a nice block from Joe Flading, the tackle. You see him, number 78, pulling around right there. He kicked out Renfro. The linebacker, Darius Marshall, cuts inside of that. And then he's going to kind of work his way tightrope and along the edge of the sideline, picking up extra yards.
Clock stopped momentarily as they reset the change, but chains rather, and you see it's already winding. As Marshall stayed inbounds, and they are into Ohio territory at the 42. They go right back to Marshall. He is bottled up right around the line of scrimmage by Dak Nostein. Didn't pick up anything on that carry.
Yeah, that's the old five-yard rule, where if you gain at least 5 yards on a play, run it again. And John Shannon, the offensive coordinator, invoked that one. And he didn't quite get five that time.
Marshall, Darius Marshall out for a break. Martin Ward, who has a couple of touchdown runs and a 44-yard run from scrimmage today, back in there. There's Ward with a nice run. Steps out of bounds around the 36-yard line. Picked up six.
And a mistake getting out of bounds by Ward, but he got through the edge pretty good there. Got himself a nice block. from big number 76, Jimmy Rogers, who has had an excellent ball game up front. We've talked about him laying people out a few times.
Rogers, about 6'4", 313, senior out of Cleveland, Mississippi. Here's a 3rd and 3, Darius Marshall back in the backfield.
Ohio's got 9 in the box.
Darius Marshall trying to break outside. And he does. A terrific run by Marshall. He was being pursued by Kenny Jackson, but he outraced him to the sideline. First down.
Kenny Jackson makes a mistake right up here on the top of the screen. Watch him. He worked inside. There's no need for him to go inside. There's 10 other guys in there. He's just got to make sure that thing doesn't bust outside around him. And he kind of bought into it, stepped inside, got blocked a little bit by Jamie Hatton, and then Darius Marshall's just too quick, and he got the edge for the first down. A critical play by the Thundering Herd.
Inside of 3 minutes. And they go right back to Marshall. Missed the last two games of the regular season with the hurt ankle, but has looked mighty fine today. That's 3 more yards for him. He comes out, Martin Ward comes back in, and you see the two of them have combined for almost 150 yards.
That's a pretty good 1-2 punch right there. With, you know, we expected Darius Marshall to have the numbers Ward has down there, but Ward has been really impressive today. He's, I don't know if Darius has still got that ankle. He probably is not quite 100%, but Martin Ward is.
5 plays for 29 yards on this drive, all of them runs. Marshall might have gotten away with a little bit of movement on the left side of their line. Lee Smith, the tight end, moved his feet early.
No doubt about it.
But there's no flag right.
That should be a penalty there. That's one they got away with there. Definitely a false start by Lee Smith, the tight end. But yet the officials didn't see it.
Minute 45 left to go in this ball game. Ohio has called timeout. Coach Solich wants to know why they didn't call that a penalty. This is the last timeout for the Bobcats. 3rd and 6 coming up for Marshall, hanging on to a 4-point lead over Ohio.
You know, truck guys, they like to get the job done right.
Measure twice, cut once, I always say.
Let me give you a hand there. Did you know that this Silverado has 315 horsepower? How about your F-150?
Bless.
Silverado's powertrain is back for 5 years or 100,000 miles. Yours?
40,000 miles less.
Don't blame the carpenter. Blame the tool.
Now, during the Chevy Red Tag event, get an 09 Silverado with 0% APR for 72 months. See red and save green now at your local Chevy dealer.
I'm all shook up.
I need pain relief that won't mess with my grip.
The new Icy Hot No Mess Applicator. Massages in long-lasting relief for shoulders, knees, backs, even arthritis. Icy to dull pain, hot to relax it away. Icy Hot No Mess Applicator.
No pain, no mess.
Verizon makes a big deal about their maps, but when you look a little closer, their story begins to fall apart. See, AT&T lets you talk on the phone while you surf the web. Verizon doesn't. AT&T has the most popular smartphones and the nation's fastest 3G network. Verizon doesn't. Glad that's cleared up.
Oh, AT&T, a better 3G experience. This holiday, get a touchscreen Samsung Solstice free after mail-in rebate.
When fire or water damage strikes your business, call the cleanup team that's faster to any size disaster at 1-800-SERV-PRO, like it never even happened.
Well, welcome back. It is Capital One Bowl Week. Coming up next, the Meineke Car Care Bowl. North Carolina playing in nearby Charlotte, taking on Pittsburgh. Then we'll have an ESPN News postgame extra. And you don't want to miss the trophy ceremony right here on ESPN360.com. Will it be Marshall? Will it be Ohio? Marshall with a 3rd and 6 and a 4-point lead. Anderson over the middle, completes it, but a couple of yards short of the first down to his tight end, Lee Smith. All right, here you go, Ray. You're about 4th and 2. Do you try to get the first down and hang on the ball for the rest of the game, or do you
I think you go for it. You go for it, especially if you're Rick Minter, who you're in a situation where you're an interim coach and you've got your guys down there. They've worked hard for you. They came out flying early. I don't think you need to kick the football here. You've been stopping them. I would go for it. I'd let the time run down as far as I could. Ohio can't stop the clock, and I would go for it.
Marshall does have all three of its timeouts remaining. You see him looking up at the and calling the timeout with 2 seconds. Now 1 second left on the play clock. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN tonight. We'll take you out to San Francisco for the Emerald Bowl. Montel Harris of Boston College taking on Pete Carroll's Trojans. Capital One Bowl Week continues on ESPN at ESPN360.com tonight at 8 Eastern. So stay with us. It's the Meineke Car Care Bowl followed by the Emerald Bowl coming up, part of Capital One Bowl Week. Timeout taken here. We'll take this time. This is our last game, Ray. What a great season it's been. Very good sign by those fans. Brian Ryder, our producer, Dan McVann, our director, a terrific crew that we've had the privilege of working with.
Yeah, again this year. In the truck, and it's been a great year.
Evan Cohen, our AP.
Yeah, Evan's done a great job.
Tom Von Berg, Elaine Robb, Mike Moody, and the incomparable Brian Sachs, our camera people.
Oh boy.
And here's Greg Rutanamorn. They are bringing him in for a 40-yard field goal attempt. He's a good field goal kicker. But he doesn't get that one. So they do not go for it.
Yeah, I'm not an I told you so guy, but and I understand with Rutanamorn, he's only missed one field goal all year. So, you know, in fact, that's his first miss over 40 yards all year. So here's a guy that you know you can count on. And very, very close. I mean, he banged it off the left upright. And it did not go through. And so now Ohio has a little bit better field position. And they got to go down and get a touchdown. And they don't have any timeouts. But they have done this. This is a cardiac-type team.
And the Bobcats pull it out. They are 0-for-3 in their previous bowl appearances. Theo Scott running the offense from the 23. And that's incomplete. Clock stops with 53 seconds left to go. He was looking for Chris Garrett out of the backfield. But a little play like that, a little completion over the middle, all you can hope for is that Garrett can break it. Otherwise, you're going to waste a lot of time.
Yeah, they have to stop a clock. I think it's probably better for Ohio that Garrett didn't catch that one. They really, you know, there is enough time to work the middle of the field, especially if you get a first down. But I think their primary point of attack is going to be the edges, the sidelines.
Taylor Price, their best wide receiver, is split out wide right, number 23 in green. Scott rolls that way, then dinks it off to Brazil, who goes out of bounds with 46 seconds left to go. 3rd and 6 coming up.
Theo Scott has been in this situation. You see, he's led the 3 fourth-quarter comebacks this season, and several of those were right down to the wire. Not comebacks that happened early in the fourth quarter. They were late.
Brazil limps off, so Bakari Bussey, Barney's son, Barney playing in the NFL. His son Bakari in there on 3rd and 6, obviously 4-down territory the rest of the game for Ohio. Scott flushed out of the pocket, throws it, and it's picked off. Inter- intercepted by Daquan Bembry, and that should just about do it for the Thundering Herd.
Theo Scott tried to force that one into Taylor Price, and Bembry had the coverage right where he needed to be. And this Marshall Thundering Herd hangs on. And they are excited about that. And Ohio, well, they'll have to try again as they do not get their first bowl win in school history.
Ohio and Marshall, the two schools about 80 miles apart. They will start a regular season series up again next year. You said it right there, Scott, forcing it in. And Bembry comes up with his third pick of the season.
This Marshall defense, even though they got pushed around a little bit in the second half, they rose up when they had to. And Coach Minter got himself a bath he wasn't expecting.
We certainly hope that he gets another opportunity to be a head coach again. He really handled this transition with grace, passed over in favor of Doc Holliday to be the head coach at Marshall starting next season. Now for today's player of the game, brought to you by Capital One. And we are going to go with the running back, Martin Ward. A couple of touchdown runs, career high for him, and also a 44-yard run. So Marshall finishes with its first winning season since 2003. They go to 7-6 on the year, and their first bowl win since they won the GMAC Bowl back in 2002.
Yeah, and hats off to Rick Minter and his staff for overcoming the adversity of losing Coach Snyder, Mark Snyder, resigning at the end of the season. Minter appointed, had the disappointment of not getting the job that he had, you know, he threw his hat in the ring for, and yet he hung in there, he got his team focused, and they came out of the gates 21-0 early, and they hang on to pull this one out.
Yep, Marshall at one point up 21-0, win at 21-17. We invite you to turn over to ESPN News for a post-game extra, and don't forget to log on to ESPN360.com for live coverage of the trophy ceremony down on the field. Thanks, Ray, for another great season. All the ladies and gentlemen in the truck and on the field that make this the best job in the world. Marshall, the 2009 Little Caesars Bowl champions, the Meineke Car Care Bowl coming up next on ESPN. Happy holidays, everybody. We say so long from Detroit.
All right, Pam, in just over 20 minutes, you'll see one of the great young stars in college football. Deion Lewis won the Big East Freshman and Player of the Year. Michael Vick, the only other guy to ever do that. Pitt and Carolina coming up.